None of the trails are even updated.
Do you have the New York State map? So download, it's $5. Download the New York State app.
Oh, but I have to.
And then when you have the app, download the non-internet map. It'll download your phone. So then if you don't have internet, you don't get lost.
So for y'all who are just now listening, my buddy over here, Scrooge, got lost snowmobiling the other day.
Yeah, we were all the way in Camden after the fact of the matter that we were supposed to be in Parrish at 9 o'clock. So we started at 9 in the morning. I didn't get back. I had to call my dad because we had no gas, no nothing. We were at the McDonald's in Camden.
Do you have a caddy?
Yeah, we used it. Jesus. Everything.
So you got to base your rides off of where the next food stop is and then where the next
gas stop is. It gets dark out.
Yeah. See, we always base, like, okay, how much gas we got? All right, we can make it here, get some food, and then we can make it there.
You've never been lost?
Me?
Yeah.
So I've never been lost. That's probably because I ride with Vince, and he knows Tug Hill like the back of his hand.
See, I never...
But I did get stranded one day, so you know Chris Brinswa.
Yeah.
So I called Chris Brinswa. I'm like, yo, let's meet at the island on Oneida Lake. So we fucking... He's like, all right, I'll meet you there. I'm fucking coming from Panther Lake, so I'm fucking hossing down C4. I fill up at Cleveland. No fucking clouds in the sky. I fucking cross. I fucking get to the island. I smoke a fucking jammy. I'm fucking waiting for him. You know how Grandpa is, dude. He fucking takes his damn sweet fucking time everywhere. I'm like, all right, so where you at? He's like, I'm starting my sled right now. I'm like, all right, and then fucking half hour goes by. I'm like, where are you at? He's like, yo, I'm at Boreos. I can't see the island. I'm in the lighthouse, so I don't see snow. I fucking come out of the lighthouse. Can't see fucking 2 feet in front of me. He's like, I can't get you. I was like, you gotta get me. What do you mean? I don't know where land is. I don't know where nothing is. He goes, as soon as this fucking snowstorm lets up a little bit, I'll fucking come out. As soon as you see me, follow my trails all the way the fuck back to Boreos. I'm like, all right. I fucking see a light coming. It took him like 30 minutes just to get there because he didn't want to fucking go the wrong way either. And the only place you could see the island from in a snowstorm is Boreos. So he leaves Boreos. I get there. I go back, dude. I literally thought I was going to sit on that fucking island for fucking like 4 or 5 hours till this storm let out. It was.
You're talking about that island right in the middle, right?
Yeah.
The lighthouse. Right off the boat launch, right?
Yeah.
Right
Bridgeport. Yeah.
Yeah, that's where, like, my landlord, we went out there one night, like, had some beers and shit, rode the four wheelers out there.
Yeah, it's fun out there. Yeah. People always build a big bonfire out there. They're out in the lake right now, drag racing in front of the old Coopers.
Yeah. It's still so the lake is
there's no snow on it, so me and you running fucking big tracks. We
nothing. We're
no
roasted.
Studs. We roasted. There's no fucking snow to cool our sleds down. But the drag sleds, they fucking do fucking 2 laps and they're fucking let it cool down. Do 2 laps.
Yeah,
let it cool down.
Yeah.
That ain't my style, right?
No, that's boring. But yeah, with me getting lost, with the facts of the matter, so we wound up. Well, we were with 4 of us, so I rode with 3 of them before. The one's just a fucking idiot.
Who is it?
Well, one of them was my buddy down. His name's Corbin. He lives down in PA.
And then what happened to Corbin?
Who is Corbin?
And so what happened was the one guy that was being our designated fucking
GPS,
he loses his phone. Falls out of his pocket. And it's freezing rain up there Wednesday night, so my suit is literally a sheet of fucking ice. So, and then I have icicles just down here. And all of a sudden, we're just in the middle of just C4. And then all of a sudden, just no trail was marked after that.
If you
went
south on C4.
Yeah.
And then if you, right when you come into Panther Lake, my mom's house, you go
through.
Yeah,
I've been there, yeah.
Yeah, you go through, you've been there 100 times. The trail goes through my mom's backyard, mm-hmm. So you literally could have went there and found your way anywhere.
No, I just said, screw it. Then we lost that guy.
You lost him?
The GPS guy.
So he went home, or you just
lost him? Oh, yeah, he found it all of a sudden. We're at 8:30 at night. We're at fucking Camden fucking McDonald's. This idiot, the one that we called the idiot the whole fucking night, he calls us, hey, I'm back at the truck. Where are you guys?
When did you lose him, though? Like, that's why
we lost him at 8:30. All of a sudden, we took one long turn, and he...
You didn't wait for him at the
we
stop
waited.
Signs?
He never showed back up. We waited 15
So, like,
minutes.
All right, give me a better timeline. So, it's like, all right, we go out riding. Okay. He loses the phone. You guys lose him.
No, so we waited for him for 40 minutes to go find the phone. Two of them went back. So, there's four of us. Two of us sat there. So, just to conserve gas, just in case. Then two of them went back. They went for 40 minutes. They found his phone. Somehow, they fucking found his phone. Then, when we went back up, then all of a sudden, we went down a trail. He was following us. We waited. Then, all of a sudden...
No GPS guy.
No GPS guy. He just disappeared. We did not. We called him. Everything. Nothing. Then all of a sudden, when we get to, we're reading trails, and all of a sudden we're trying everything you can at nighttime when nothing's marked right.
No.
We all of a sudden wind up in Camden, when we're supposed to be a fucking parrot, Chris Mill.
Opposite way.
30 minutes in a car, and then my buddy's like, "Well, there's a gas station down there." I'm like, "Yeah." I'm like, we're 4 hours away probably on a sled right now. I go, all the 3 hours. I go, yeah, I'm just going to call my dad. I was like, it's the most late. I'm fucking 29 years old. I'm like, dad. I just had, you know what I mean?
Could have called me. I would have been like, I'm on my way.
It was fucking horrible.
Or I would have been like, yeah, go back down this trail, that trail. I'll cut over here and been like, yeah. No.
John said he was, I was done.
I was freezing. I had to pay fucking a McDonald's employee to fucking sit inside because they shut the fucking thing.
What?
Yeah, dude.
Jesus.
Like they weren't letting anybody
they
in the lobby?
They weren't letting anybody in, and like they had the door open, and I walked in there. And they're like, oh, it's closed. And I'm like, well, I'm freezing. I go, here's $5. I go, just let me sit here until somebody comes and picks me up. I go, I'm literally fucking frozen.
So you should probably get a chatterbox. So if you get a chatterbox, whoever I ride with usually has a chatterbox. So if I got to call you, it rings in your helmet, and you can talk to him on your helmet. Or I could push a button. It's like a walkie-talkie. I could be like, yo, John, we're taking a left. Yo, John, stop up. We're missing someone. Yeah. Yo, fucking John, fucking,
we
need
gas. That's
some
fucking 007 shit, dude. What, like everybody has one?
Yeah. So you just you pick a channel so you're not fucking interfering with other people on the trail that have them, and you fucking press a button. You have a button on your headset that's on the outside of your helmet, and then you have a button on your handlebar. So I can press the button on the handlebar to talk to you.
Agent Cody,
I can jam out the fucking, you know, riffraff and fucking Vinny vibing whenever I want, jamming, press a button, fucking talk to you. Incoming call, my wife's bitching at me, come fucking home, no, I'm riding, fucking, I'll be home in 2 hours.
Congratulations to on that, by the way.
I can't wait, that's going to be fun. Or a business call comes in, yo, I'll call you back, I know you need powder coat, none, I'll be fucking done in an hour and a half, I'll call you, whatever.
Jackson Power Cone, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, Jackson Power Cone, get your power coat done.
Get it done.
Get it done, get power coated.
You know what Jackson's after, right?
What?
Derek.
Is it?
Derek's nickname was Jackson, so I was like, you know, I called Dickie up. I'm like, yo, I kind of figured out my name. I got to run it by you. I can't just steal your son's name, but I want to use it. He said, fucking run with it, dude. I'm like, all right, sweet.
I was curious on where that came from. Cause
a lot of people keep asking me. They're like, that wasn't his nickname. It was like D-Rock. I'm like, no, that's his gamer tag. His nickname was Jackson. And it wasn't like, so I grew up with him since I was a month old, so I didn't really know him as Jackson, but it still is
weird
because
when you say that,
thing.
I forgot he was even called Jackson.
Yeah,
like,
not a lot of people know it, but it's. I wasn't gonna be like, yo, my name's Derek Powdercoating or Derek Weiland Powdercoating or something. It wouldn't be. That's not right. I was like, fuck it. Nickname Jackson's like a common fucking whatever you use name, and actually Tatiana's the one that fucking came up with it.
Really.
She was like, what do you feel about using, like, incorporating Derek into this company? I was like, perfect. Spot on. Couldn't get any better.
That shit's fire. I've been meaning to get out to Alex's new joint, too. The restaurant there or whatever?
The bar.
Finish Line Bar, yeah, right in Rota in front of the Speedway. It's doing all right. Alex is never there.
Yeah, I know. I've just been meaning to go just to support. I don't know.
Yeah, I mean... He's never there, but he's obviously supportive of it. It's RJ Buds and Eric Farley. They all decided to do the bar, and then Alex's stepdad.
I saw Eric Farley not too long ago. I can't remember where the fuck I saw him.
And then Alex's dad's the one that manages it, and it's doing good, I think. I mean, it's hard to compete with all the...
There's so much going on.
There's so much in Brewerton going on, and then not only that is that bar is really hard to get going. There's been, 10 different bars there in the last 7 years.
Yeah.
But if they do
it, all depends on who you know too.
And you got who you know, and you got to get bands, get you in there for some nights, get a whole different, just not set your tone on one crowd. You got to, there's rednecks, there's hip hop, there's hippies.
Yeah,
there's,
but it's hard. Dude. A lot of hip hop fucking won't even book anymore. Like, no. You need a full band to book a lot of places downtown now.
And if you do like hip hop, you're going to have like all of our friends there. That's it. You know what I mean? I don't think anyone else is going to come up from the city or anything to come there.
Yeah, because it's, so it's kind of far.
James, all them people, and then that's about it. You know,
We just came back from the weed farmer's market.
The weed farmer's market?
Yeah, bro, they just have these fucking pop-ups. This one's just every
fucking... My buddy Nick was there. He said he seen you.
Oh, yeah?
Nick, remember you met him out at my mom's house? The dab
Nick,
guy?
Nick.
Remember the tubs?
Okay.
Yeah, so he was like, oh, I seen that dude there. I didn't want to, like, walk up to him and be like, yo, I know you. And I was like, you could have. Yeah.
He's
like,
probably not going to remember.
No, he goes, that's the vibe and dude with Riff Raff, right? Yeah. I go, yeah. That's how he knows you. He's like, yeah, I jam to that sometimes. I'm like, good.
Fucking, he fucking drove me the whole time.
He told me, he goes, I drove the whole time. I was like, fuck.
Riff Raff got him in trouble fucking smoking fucking blunts in the wife's car, smoking Johns in the wife's car.
Yeah, the wife yelled at me. She called him a little weasel.
Riff Raff's wife?
No, his wife.
Oh, your wife.
When they came up to Syracuse, I went over to the tour bus. I got invited.
It was mad funny because I get like, you know, they hit me out there. Yo, you know, we need some green. You want to come through and shit? I'm like, yeah, I got you. We fucking pull up. And I'm chilling on the bus. And the DJ's like, he's like, Lebowski's here. I'm like, what the fuck? He's like, Lebowski's here, dude. I'm like, what the fuck you mean? He's like, Lebowski's here. And then for some reason, like, homie never even tells John to come in. Like, I'm just sitting there. John, it was like 20 minutes later.
So John's
like,
there. You're not even there?
No, I'm in the bus right now. I didn't know John was coming.
You?
No, I didn't even know he was coming. The DJ hit up John and told John to pull up, too. So, but John's just sitting out in the car. He didn't even tell him to come in. I was like, what do you mean? He's like, tell him to come in.
To Walmart. They were like, yo, we gotta go to Walmart. And I'm fucking, he's like walking over to the car, and I'm like, yo, my wife says no smoking in the car. And then he was about to put it out. Like, he even said, all right. I was like, she's gonna yell at me. I go, boy, I was like, he goes, no, just tell her it's me. I'm a piece of shit, he says. So, he was very respectful, actually. I told him, I was like, just buy some Osium. And I was like, just spray it. And then he did. That was no problem.
Yeah, that's but, shoot over to zone.
So, fucking, you guys are obviously big fucking snowmobile mofos. Let's talk some fucking tech. What's your favorite thing to ride? Yeah. I know you got
some titties.
Great answer. I can actually ride them myself. You know, I'm about that. Yeah, I'll ride some. I'm a motorboater.
Motorboating some bitch.
You and vehicles just. That's not your forte, Vin.
Oh, no. I'll crash it. I was joking about.
I can see him on a Vespa. Like a tuned up two stroke.
Dude, I fucking. That's when I broke my collarbone on.
He broke his collarbone on one.
Yeah, but you can't just break it and get off.
Oh, no. I'm going to ride again. You got to keep on riding.
That was literally jet ski, dude.
I'm jet skiing all day. That's what I'm doing next year. Jet ski, dude. I love jet skis.
My girlfriend or my fiance and me love the jet ski.
Ryan loves jet skiing, too.
Dude, we literally could ride from Oneida Lake to Cross Lake, and it is the fuck.
Because
you just see mansions on the river the whole day, and you're just cruising at a good 30, drinking some brews with people. Me and Casey from Case Closed.
I love jet skiing.
Awesome. We just did we went fucking balls to the wall the way to fucking Cross Lake, and then putted on the way back. It was fun as shit.
Not really a big water person.
I feel like I'm an everything.
Pick, I mean, you can't even pick between the two, could you?
Jet skiing and snowmobiling?
Yeah.
Snowmobiling.
Yeah?
I'll pick snowmobiling. My girlfriend can be like laid out in some lingerie, and if there's 4 foot of snow outside, I'm going to tell her.
So, all right, so you're saying you're riding some titties. What's your favorite? Like, what are you riding right now?
Well, there's only one brand to ride.
Skidoo.
So we're not even gonna fight with that. I had a piece of shit Polaris in my house yesterday.
Polaris.
Yeah, dude.
Arctic crap.
Yeah, dude, it was fucking.
Are they really that bad?
No,
they're not bad. Actually, the new Polaris's. If you're doing like a hill climb, the new Polaris's Matrix chassis. I went to the Turn Hill Drags. They were dominating. Yeah. Dominating.
Is that where they just go up the fucking hill?
Yeah, Matt Lukey fucking was on a Polaris 800.
Yeah, but they're also
nuts. He won every race.
Stock. The slashes are 3 horsepower, I think 3 more pounds boost.
Yeah.
I think it's 8 pounds over, I think 5, maybe 4.
My problem with that shit is you always break sun snowmobiling. Have you ever you've gone a season without breaking anything?
Yeah. I don't think I broke anything ever on my snowmobiles.
Come on.
And I ride them hard. Okay, so my first snowmobile I had was a race.
Didn't break a ski. Nothing.
No. Nope.
I've never blown up a snowmobile.
I've never blown up a snowmobile.
I'll do all of the above first week.
Rental.
So the only thing I have ever broke, it was because I bought a race sled that was actually in a snowcross race sled, and it like mixed oil, all that shit on the trail sucked. But I think the shocks were worn out so bad when I bought it, the shock broke, went through my track and ripped my track. Then I paid Preston at Rocks to redo my whole track and everything, and I got right back out in a week. But other than that, I've never broken anything. But
yeah, blowing a belt.
That's like fucking changing
your
oil.
Even
yeah.
if you rip your track or your tracker, that's honestly
it's
switching your tires.
It's wear and tear. It's like your tires on a car.
Clutch braking. That's more common than what.
I've never fucked with anything.
I had that happen last year. I had my rollers just broke.
Yeah, but that's wear and tear.
I should have done it before the season.
I actually just got in the mail today my Sledhead racing clutch, and I'm putting that on too. So
SHR,
I can't
your John Wilmer SHR?
You snowboard and shit?
Snowboard?
Yeah.
I tried when I was younger. I only did some jibbing. I never went on the mountain, but yeah. I know the lingo. I feel like if I get up on that mountain and I look down, dude, it's over with. I'm going to be like, fuck this, bring me back down. Because I'm terrified of heights. Like, if I'm on, like, a machine, I'm not scared of heights. But if I'm on, like, a board, like, I can stop by sitting on my ass.
That's interesting. That's cool.
All my friends snowboard, though. Like, everyone. Turner snowboards. My buddy Billy.
I've seen Turner forever.
Billy Stallbrook snowboards. My buddy Jay Rude snowboards.
I'm too old for my
life. You know Jay Rude.
Jared, yeah.
He snowboards. A lot of people I know snowboard. I just never got into. My mom skied for her whole life. That's how she broke both of her knees. She was coming down Song Mountain and fucking shattered both of her knees. Had both of her knees reconstructed. I just never
Every
got
time
into
I see you, you got something new broken.
Sometimes.
That's what you break. You break your hand. You know, you break.
I break my
you
hands.
You break something.
I break something. It's my body.
That was my Actually, second thing. You break
the last thing
you break
I broke
fucking...
was, I don't know, I didn't really break it, but I fucked my wrist up. Last thing I really broke was when I got shot. Fucking 3 vertebrae.
Your wrist was pretty fucked up. That was a skeeter, though, wasn't it?
Yeah,
the
jet ski.
Jet ski, yeah.
And then when I got out of prison, I had hernia. But that was because shot cam fucking put you through the works. Derek broke my ankle when I was younger.
ACL.
I broke both my ankles twice, actually. My buddy in high school, you remember when people used to rhino each other? Knee in the ass. My buddy TJ did that to me and broke my tailbone in school. Other than that, no, I haven't really broken a lot. I just get banged up a lot. I might crash, but
I broke my ribs a lot snowboarding. I broke it. I had like a
that's
fucking,
that's
like,
what everyone breaks when they snowboard is their ribs.
The tumble.
And yeah. It's usually like or like you fall on a rail.
Plus I was going on like a
you launch air a lot with it.
Yeah,
it was like a 9-1
like skateboarding.
I kept re-breaking them. Like I broke them at a concert, broke them like I was getting better, started exercising. I was doing a plank and just heard a pop. I'm like, oh. And then fucking
dude,
again,
Leffler, Leffler can do a plank for like 3 minutes.
I bet.
He's a fucking intense little guy.
I haven't seen him in forever either.
You broke your collarbone. I still don't get how you broke your collarbone.
He's fast as fuck, dude.
Fast as fuck, boy.
I got caught in the rain and slid, dude.
Oh, that makes more sense. I was like on a scooter. Just like me. Is it 2-stroke or 4-stroke?
Probably 2-stroke.
You don't know.
Have you seen it?
I saw it like, dude. I saw it like twice.
Bro, so the first time ever riding anything.
Does it go
yee
or does
it's
it go boom?
It's a
2-stroke.
Yee,
2-stroke. That's my interpret on is it 2-stroke or 4-stroke? Does it go yee or does it go woo?
It goes yee. It's definitely
a
yee. Fucking dude, my first time getting, I was talking about it earlier in the car because these guys don't know what a lawn job is. I'm like, I don't know a lawn job, dude. Just a little fucking ride to the yard real quick accidentally.
Yo,
or intentionally.
Do you remember? You were hanging out at the trap house back in the day. Do you remember when Loeffler drove through my lawn?
No.
It was middle of winter. I'm pissing up in my the upstairs bathroom, and I look out the window, and fucking Leffler's doing a donut around my fucking trap house in his fucking car. I'm fucking trying to stop pissing and fucking get down and yell at him. He parks it in the backyard, and I'm like, what are you doing? And he's fucking hammered, and I'm like, why are you driving? And he's like, I don't know. Is this a good spot to park? I'm like, no, dude. Get in the driveway, job, dude.
He's never done a lawn job, dude. I told him it's overdue. Nice. When I first bought the scooter, dude, I never drove it before. So I was like, fuck it. We're like, I have Billy, you know, Billy Aker. He's following me home. And I fucking, like, I take a turn. It's my first turn ever on a fucking motor type cycle. And I fucking just, I had to huck it through like 6 yards.
So the thing with motorcycles, people don't understand is they think you have to turn.
Yeah.
You don't turn. It's just all you fucking lean.
See, and that's why, like.
So I went to the motorcycle course. You press on the handlebars. So if you're just on something and start on like a pit bike or something and press on the handlebars on each side, and you'll be like, oh shit, that's how you turn. Not.
You also have to look. You have to, like, if like you can't just, like, if you're going through a turn and you're just looking straight, the bike is going to go straight.
Yeah, I've never had any issues besides the rain.
Wherever your eyes go, your body.
And then when I got back on it after fucking, like, I'm like, I was so excited to ride again. Like, I loved it, dude. Shit only went fucking 50. I still fucking loved riding. I like the lean. The lean's what I like. Like, it took me back to, like, riding a bike as a kid. But when I rode that fucking thing again, it just felt like the wheels on it are this fucking big. They're this fucking big. Like, so it, like, dude, you feel every fucking bump. Oh, so when I got back on that thing, dude, it was just like, I was like, I don't like.
You probably didn't check the air time.
Oh, no, I'm sure I bent some shit when I fucking slid.
It's like you get on a BMX bike. When you turn a BMX bike, do you turn the handlebar?
No, you
lean.
Yeah.
So that's the same thing with motorcycle. You lean. Yeah. You don't turn. It's weird. It's a weird concept to get over, too, because, like, when I first started riding, I was 16, I got my motorcycle license, and I thought you turned, and you don't fucking turn.
See, I'm a cruiser, though, too, so I wouldn't want anything too fast.
But then you go
to
a snowmobile,
either,
and it's a whole different fucking
snowmobile
ball
game. Is like, I don't even understand. Best thing is, like, a four-wheeler. If you're comparing a snowmobile or anything, it's a four-wheeler. You do turn.
I think you can fucking whip a four-wheeler a little fucking better than you can.
No. Yeah.
No, it also depends on the sled, too. Let's be.
Like mine and your sled is.
I'm not going in. Look, I go to a.
You're not railing.
I'm at
a corner.
50, maybe at a corner. I don't like going much.
No.
I'm not trying
now
to.
Now you're on a Renegade or an MXZ. Renegade or MXZ, they're built for the trail, and you got dual carbides. You're going to fuck. It feels. I got on my buddy Vince's from my sled. It felt like an F1 car compared to my sled. Uh-huh. It felt like I was fucking just. And I was like, whoa, dude, what the fuck? He goes, yeah, that thing.
But
when
you. Bump wise, they suck.
They suck.
I'm
just a little lost as a non snowmobiler. So that one can turn really well.
Yes.
But fucking, you hit a bump,
it's fucking
just
jerking
not,
you around.
There's less
it's like
of
your
a travel. That
it's like your moped to a Harley.
Yeah.
Moped, and you can turn real sharp because it's got a shorter wheelbase on a fucking. Our long track snowmobiles, you're not railing fucking corners, but the moguls, the bumps, you fucking just skim right across them, so you don't even feel them.
First time I tried a wheelie on that shit, it was mad funny. I fucking suck at wheelies to begin with. There's this gentleman named Duffy, dude, and anybody who's watching this, there's probably a few people out there who know Duffy, and he's like, do a wheelie. So I was like, fuck it, and I fucking am just running it down the street. I got it. I didn't get good at it. Like I watched a couple of YouTube videos, dude. They make it seem so butter. They're just like,
yeah, because they know exactly where the clutch and the wheel and the balance point.
It's all about where they know the balance point. Yeah. And like they're throwing their weight to the balance.
And let's be real, I have trouble balancing standing up.
Yeah.
So.
The best thing for you to ride though, to get the hang of everything, is just a pit bike.
I feel a dirt bike's good too.
That's what a pit bike is. It's a small dirt bike. It's called a pit bike because they ride around
though,
the pits.
That's probably what, like, you ever meet Shells? You just hang out with James and shit.
Yeah.
With the Shells fucking. I remember seeing him on a little fucking pulling up with James out in Bridgeport on a little.
Yo, I miss that dude. He used to chill at the house
Shells?
Every day.
He's my entertaining.
My trap house was great. Imagine Shells and Zach Coleman together. That's how it was every day in my house. It was unreal.
I need them on the podcast for a day, dude. Zach Coleman is a funny motherfucker, man.
He is.
He gets me going. He's a hype too. Like every time I see him, it's a good time.
Dude, I have some videos of him fucking just sitting, fucking DMX barking, just fucking.
One night we were fucking driving. You know how James used to live on Bull Road?
Bull.
Or
Island?
Island, yeah, Island. Fucking like the same fucking road. But boat roads off, like, turns into an island. But anyways, fucking, there was a bunch of deer out, and, like, the fucking, the golf course, and Coleman's like, dude, he's like, give me a knife. He's like, I'm gonna fucking get a deer, dude. I'm like, you're nice. He was like, I don't know if he was just doing his joke and shit, but he went on about 20 minutes. He's like, I can go get one of these deer now, dude. He's like, just let me go.
Out
get
of all him. Of our friends, he'd probably be the one.
I mean, he's deer like, dude. He's
the biggest. You know?
It's not even that he's that big. I think he's just got a long stride.
Yeah.
So he could fucking dunk on a deer.
Nah, the deer takes two steps, it's gone.
I remember being at the fair with him. He's like, I'm just trying to stay low. I'm like, you can't stay low, dude. You're 8 feet tall. Like, yeah, everybody. You're how I find the squad. Like, yeah. There it is.
There they are. They're over there.
I James came to my last show, actually. The one me and Riff did at fucking Westcott. We ended up picking shit. Fucking, he was.
He's all daddied up.
Yeah, what was weird is he kept trying to, like, push fucking Secretes and Corey's, the Moondusa. You know their NFT? You know Secreti and them, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, well, they
Secreti,
yeah.
I'm the one that introduced all them guys to Secreti.
That's what I figured. But, fucking, he's got a line of NFTs called Moondusa, and they did, like, a Riff collab. And, like, James was like, yeah, you gotta, like, I'm like, so I, like, talked to him, and then they already had it, like, lined up. I'm like, why the fuck are you trying to, like, ask me to talk to them and, like, sending me the pictures and, like, telling me, like, he had it all fucked up, but.
Yeah, they. Them guys are always trying to just do the most, and I'm just trying to lay back and
watch. They do the most.
Yeah, they do.
It seems like it works for them. I've had ideas for, like, the NFT world, what I would want to do.
I honestly don't even know what a fucking NFT is.
Digital art.
It's just digital art.
Oh, so, like.
But no, but, like, people make online.
It's a way for, it's a lot of ways.
So it's like your profile picture.
Basically, yeah, that could be it.
Yeah.
But then, like, it's sold as, like, I got what you mean.
So what I would do, though, is I would do real art NFTs. So I would take a picture of this, upload this, and then when the person bought the NFT, they'd also get the art.
That's pretty dope.
So you're not getting a bullshit just digitally made. Because what most people do is make, like, even their Moondusa is one fucking image that they just change up. Like, they fucking gave it the goddamn riffraff mustache.
Yeah, fucking James is actually was always good at drawing just random crazy shit.
He has some cool shit, dude. He has, like.
Now, Secreti on the internet, I don't know if he could draw. I know he can eat, but I don't know if he can draw.
I know he can eat. We went to EST together, dude. James and they were fucking killing me.
So do you think they're going to do another EST? My fiance has been, wants to go so fucking bad again.
One of my favorite weekends of my life. I hope they do.
I was in jail, so I didn't even get to go.
See, you know what's crazy is I've even missed the good ones. Because they had it at a different location that they're no longer allowed to have it at.
The place with the jump, the water jump?
No, they
jump?
Still have the water jump, but they don't even allow you to do that there anymore. They literally, like, pick, like, six people. It's fucked up what they do now. They'll pick, like, six people, and they'll be like, all right, you six get to go just so they can shoot a promo video for the next year.
And then no one gets to go. Because I remember James was doing, like, 10
back. Dude, yeah. I got fucked up, ruptured my eardrum, dude. Cause I tried a fucking little backflip McTwisty, but they didn't. There was no hold bars. People were going down doubles, drinking beers. Like, they would have let you take a bike down that fucking thing if you walked up the fucking staircase with it.
Jeez.
They didn't. The only thing you had to do is make sure you got hosed down before you went. And that's another reason I think they're like, yeah, we just don't have.
And plus with COVID.
The last EST was pre-COVID, so that's.
World saw.
So, like, my lake.
It was the cool. That thing
imagine
was the
if we
thing.
Could do something
dude, build
in
one
my
of those?
Lake.
Dude, I'll throw it down if we can build one of those.
I guarantee we could. Panther
Bro,
Lake is
a
private lake.
On
we can do whatever we want there as long as you're a fucking resident.
I think we could probably. I don't know. I don't. With lumber right now is a little expensive. So.
No, I went back down.
Did it?
Yeah.
Okay.
Awesome. I built my fucking office for fucking like $1,000.
Really?
Yeah. My office is what? Size of this room? Just shape different?
Yeah.
John's seen it.
What do you mean? Like, you built, like, a little fucking...
Yeah, so in my shop, it's a weird fucking shape. So it's a rectangle, and then the back wall cuts over like a fucking piece of pizza. And then fucking... So I wanted the whole garage to be square, so I built a triangular office in the back so I could have my computer. I just got a Cricut machine now, so that'll be fun to do some crazy powder coat and shit with that. And...
The Cricut, like the thing that makes fucking vinyl print.
Yeah, so what you would do is say
for
what,
your world, that's way smarter because like everybody always tries to be like, yo, I got a Cricut, you should let me make you stickers. I'm like, you can't make what I want.
You can only make one color fucking stickers.
Like,
it's not
you're
like
not
you can't print.
You can make a vinyl sticker.
So, yeah,
so in my world, So you say you want Skidoo on a piece of metal.
Boom.
And you want it, say, Skidoo's yellow. So you want a yellow Skidoo on a black sled. You would shoot it yellow, put the vinyl on it, Skidoo, and then shoot it black, peel the sticker off while it's still hot. Now you got yellow Skidoo with black.
Now, there's no, like, copyright infringements in that world?
No,
I mean, I feel
really.
Like it's kind of a gray area. You're putting it on a Skidoo. It's not like you're fucking putting it on a polo.
I think you don't really get in trouble because you're not using it to your gain.
No.
You're using it for personal. I don't really think you can get... Once I think it's a gray area. Once you start,
if I tried to sell, or if I make a product, or if I try to sell that fucking logo on the Cricut machine, like say I made the sticker and I was like, yo, you want to buy this? Then
that's
it would
a
be
little
a
different. Like but for you, yeah. But for you to fucking peel the sticker off and then replace it with another one, because
it's like
not.
It's like so. Say I went and painted a painting and it has a fucking Skidoo and I wrote Skidoo on it. That's exactly what the fuck it is. I can't get in trouble for writing Skidoo on something.
Yeah.
You know.
Plus, it's just like, who
you're going to fucking turn me in?
Yeah, dude, fucking Skidoo.
Skidoo.
We got him.
We got him. FBI, got him. Roll in.
Skidooski, Skidooski. Skidooski, that's
Bombardier.
Alakazam.
Bombardier.
Yo, Hunter actually just brought his fucking side by...
Miguel?
He just brought his side-by-side out on the lake today. I wonder how that's fucking going.
Was he fishing?
No, he's fucking... Side-by-side? Like a...
Four-wheeler?
Four-wheeler that with a steering wheel.
What?
Yeah, and it's fucking, it's heavy, but dude, it's out there on the lake right now. I guarantee he's blowing donuts on the fucking lake right now. He's probably having a blast.
Oh, wow.
He's got some nuts because it's still, it's only
got some
be
nuts.
What?
The dude was going fucking 95 miles an hour on fucking the railroad bed.
We used
fucking
to, you
no
know
cold
know?
Bars.
We
no
used
windshield,
to
just fucking ripping. I'm holding on for my life, like, yo, dude.
You need to stop, dude.
No, I was like, go faster, fuck it.
Y'all are wild. Y'all are wild. I became
nah,
tame.
Dude, the lake's crossable now. It's fucking nine inches fucking thick in the center.
I don't believe that.
It is. Dude, it
look,
was it
bro,
was negative 10.
You were hyping it up a few days ago.
It
you
was negative 10.
I said that there was like 3 or 4.
Weren't you saying it was like 7? What was the statement you said the other day?
I said it does.
What's the numbers you gave me?
I said that it...
drop it on here.
I said that live. Literally, once it's below, it does an inch an hour.
An inch an hour, and the last 3 days it was negative 10 degrees with a negative 30 degree wind chill, so you're looking at lots of ice.
Yeah.
And then you gotta imagine, it was already frozen before all this happened, and it had slop on top. So that
slop... It wasn't fully frozen. There was still a lot that was open.
A little, but everywhere there was slop, now you got fucking a foot of fucking ice because
it
was
slop.
Oh,
yeah, but it's still, there's still a lot of unsafe ice, though. I wouldn't say that there's a...
Over by Sylvan Beach, yes.
We sold our four-wheelers anyways because they were pieces of shit, and I was sick of fucking burying them.
Might as well just finance some nice ones. Yeah, you can't do it in the winter. You can't ride four-wheelers in the winter. It's not ideal.
Well, they go to the lake.
I like going on
the
ice.
Lake.
I just take them on the ice.
They go on the lake. Because
I'm right there, too.
Well,
you know
and it's if you're going to, like, packed where the snowmobile's already gone, you ride right over there because it's fucking
ice.
But there are some days...
Yeah,
right
there is perfect.
House. I mean, you
right
got the
perfect
little spot for
no,
it.
I think fucking...
Dude, it's only like $120 a month.
That side-by-side...
That skis are the way...
That side-by-side is, by the way, that little red thing that Scott has.
Oh, okay.
Except Hunter's is a 1,000RR Maverick.
Yeah, because it has two... You can sit four. His is like a fucking 300. It's a little fucking...
He paid like a grand for it,
though. Oh, it was an Ace? The one-seater Ace?
No, it's a two-seater. It's a two-seater. It's like a Polaris RZR, but it's the small one.
Gotcha.
The real small
550.
One. 550. Yeah, yeah. It was. He bought it blown up, and he rebuilt it.
You guys are
it.
Speaking such a foreign language to me, man.
He did all that. But
honestly, I don't know a lot about motors, but I know a lot about what machines are and they do. So it's not like... I don't know, I'm not a fucking mad scientist when it comes to shit. That's
so you
why I have.
Be like rebuilding yourself too much.
No, if rebuilding an engine, that's going to Preston at Rocks. If I have anything else, it's going to go to Casey at Case Closed.
That's where you go.
Yeah, I don't. I'll be honest. Do I know things? Yes, but do I know how to do things? No. There's totally different when you have a knowledge.
I can take
no, and I respect that
I can
that
take
too.
My bumper off. I can take my skis off. I can't fucking undo a bulkhead. I can't.
No, I'll tell you this. What I could do.
YouTube.
that I can YouTube it. I always could do. I could always rebuild a dirt bike. That's how I
tried to learn wheelie, man.
I could rebuild a dirt bike just by watching my dad over the years. That's one thing. That's
two stroke, yeah. Yes, four stroke.
Yes, T stroke. Yeah, I'm going with four stroke. 85s or 65s.
So a four stroke, you got to time it right. If you don't time it right, you're going to fucking blow it right up. It's a pain in the ass.
Yeah. That's why, aka, did I take apart my sled to have you do it? No. I did not do that. I could have probably did it, yes. But did I want to sit there and spend...
You could have watched YouTube and done it. It would have been easy.
But did I want
to? No, fuck that. No. If you can pay someone to do it for half the time and half the headache.
I'm trying to remember what the fucking name of that fucking scooter I had was. I know it was the cheapest new
scooter. It was a Ying Yang. It was a Ying Yang Yang Yang. It was like a fucking Chinese, scooter. Yeah.
So there's Tao.
No.
There's Vespa. Vino. No. Yamaha makes one.
No, it's like a green Chinese. It was like literally like your Coleman one.
Oh, really?
Yeah, dude. Yeah,
but those two-stroke, the Chinese two-stroke ones, rip.
And
it's like a fucking...
The only thing that sucked is the fucking
it's like exhaust an SSR.
Kept falling off.
And they're then, like, cheap I bought, like, fix because the parts are abundant.
Yeah.
And you blow that thing up, you can buy a new engine for $200.
Yeah,
ChineseParts.com.
Yeah. Like, you literally can just get whatever you can imagine. I mean, it's the same thing as Napa.com.
For Chinese shit.
But Napa's for Chinese shit, too.
Yeah, you can. Yeah, you can buy Napa Advanced. You can buy pretty much anything.
Anything.
That's where I buy my airplane stripper, so I can fucking strip parts for now until I get my rim strip in. Dude, when I get my rim strip in, I literally, with any part that already has powder coat on it, I dip it in for 30 minutes and I pull it out raw metal, sandblast it.
Besides
coat
mine.
I can dip yours in there.
No, remember how?
Oh, dude, that was a pain, bro. I fucking sat there for 5 hours sandblasting for no fucking reason. I looked up online how to fucking do it the right way. The only reason I still don't have it is because it's backordered for fucking 6 weeks.
When? What's do it like?
Rim strip. It's just like an acid. It goes in. It's a 55-gallon drum, and you put it in this vat, and then you just dip parts in it that are powder coated. Because powder coat is so hard to take off. That's what powder coating is. It's not like paint where you could just chip it off. Powder coating, I could smash a piece of metal with powder coating on it against another piece of metal, and it doesn't do a damn thing to it.
Because it was magnetized on.
Yeah, it was electric.
Really?
Yeah, it's like static electricity. It adheres the powder onto the metal, and then you put it in the oven, and it bakes it on. And so, like, the powder is actually kind of like it's like a silicon-based. It's fucking like plastic, and then it goes around it. And when it goes on, it fucking molds itself to the metal and in the pores and stuff. And then, like, say you do a spring, it fucking moves with the spring. So, like, if you just spray painted a spring, and as soon as that spring compresses,
it's gonna crumble.
Yeah. This stuff moves with it.
So, like, if you chip your rail, you'll see, like, the color underneath because it's not.
Well, yeah, no. At best, I know, like, we use DTM for when we paint shit, which is direct to metal.
Yeah.
But that still even fucking will peel right off.
Yeah, it peels right off. So this stuff is baked down at 400 degrees for 20 minutes. It fucking literally cooks to your metal.
So that's sick. So you got like a whole fucking kiln and shit.
It's not a kiln. It's just an oven. It's like your oven at your house, except five times as big. Mm-hmm. It's got the same burner in it and everything. I just hit it to 400 degrees, let it bake up, and it's good to go.
And it has less insulation, so it definitely gets warmer faster.
So you could also fucking, if you need to, just do like a real big order of cupcakes or something.
I wouldn't because I've done powder coating. Yeah, you could. And then now I'm offering Cerakote, which is ceramic coating for things like you could do guns, you could do any metal, plastic. He wants his keyboards all customized, so we're going to do that in the next few weeks and get that all right. Buttoned up.
I go to Maine next. I go to Michigan next week, too.
That's next week?
I head out on Tuesday.
So when we were on tour, this dude brought a fucking 50-round drum for Rick to sign. And then he ended up, this is the fucking gun he got fucking.
Yeah, so that's Cerakoted.
Yeah.
So that's like, so when you Cerakote a gun, so it's paint, but it's also ceramic coat that gets baked on most of the times.
This is the dude who got the 50-round drum.
Oh, that's pretty sweet.
So with his keyboard, we're trying to do some crazy.
Oh, shit.
Like chameleon color way with it, so it's fucking.
We'll see if it works.
We're gonna do some testing.
Yeah.
We'll I want to get testing, good with it before I fucking put my crazy name out there saying I can do some custom keyboards. No, but
that's how I was with this whole podcast
shit.
Like,
I have these little nerdy kids message you.
Hey, dude.
I would have like people even come like because I want to rent the studio out as well to other people who want to do their own podcast so they don't have to go through all the bullshit I went through building this.
Cause... Yeah, you got a nice setup here. Yeah. It's pretty nice, you know what I mean?
Next thing is just better cameras.
One thing, too.
Are you allowed to paint?
Yeah, I can paint.
I would paint each wall a different color, and...
I want to maybe get a couple artists in here to just come and freak them.
Yeah.
Mini fridge.
I thought about the mini fridge. Cold, it just gets so hot. Drinks. Dude, it usually gets hot as fuck in here. We're lucky it's so cold.
Oh, really?
It gets spicy.
Oh, you don't
in
have,
here.
Like, a thermostat?
No.
No.
No. It's cheap. It's a dollar a square foot here.
They say you can't touch here.
And the bigger ones are cheaper. Like, a 1,200 square foot one's, like, $800.
That's not bad.
No.
No wonder you moved. I would have moved, too.
Oh, fuck it. Instead of just, and my back room was way smaller. I had other shit in there too. I didn't like bringing people to my house.
It was
house.
Fucking crooked.
No, you
it's crooked. Yeah, it's crooked. The floor, so we'd just be like, by the end of the podcast, we'd be fucking.
Yeah, you'd be in the middle, just totally off camera.
This shit. I have a filing cabinet that I had to put like.
Does that window open?
Nope.
Was it say because in the summer, is the AC in here?
Yeah.
Oh, all right. I was gonna say because in the summer.
Still gets
the
hot.
AC. No, it gets decent. In the
oh,
summer.
Does it?
Yeah, the AC runs pretty well, and I've seen a couple of nice little portable ACs.
Yeah, but the portable is usually at the vent somewhere.
No, I saw one the other day. Dude, it's
Venting
at the...
out that mail slot.
Nah.
Yeah, cut a hole in the fucking
tile. Oh, yeah,
tile.
Fuck it.
I can get you a fucking one of those
I don't
things.
Even need a cut a hole. That size, like the one I have at my house, the little vent strip that it goes, is like that size right there.
Easy. Yeah. Duct tape there.
Maybe so, Jennifer, if you're watching this, my leasing agent, we're going to do that.
We need AC.
It was mad funny because in my lease, I don't know if you see that right there. That's my smoking warning.
Oh, you're not allowed to smoke in here?
Nah. It said nothing about that in my lease. And my chiropractor's in this building. That's how I found it. And he be burning mad incense. So I was like, fuck it, you know?
So wait, you're not allowed to smoke, but you're allowed?
I mean, it's nothing about it in the lease, but they said I'm not allowed to smoke. Or else they won't renew my lease. This place is cool, too, though. It's month to month.
Oh, that's not bad.
Yeah, so it's like...
I'm fucking done.
Oh, so vaping is allowed, but smoke's not?
Yeah, I mean...
Or smoke in your car.
And yeah, I know. I was pushing the limits until I found out.
Yeah, you know, he had folks
there's,
there.
Dude, there's like, on Sunday nights...
Not even that, dude. I can just get you some edibles, fucking eat them things down.
I like to just fucking smoke some kush. I had a buddy
plus
who,
if you had
who
like,
grows.
Plus, if you want to have, like, a smoking, like, a 420 podcast.
Yeah, if I had Wiz Khalifa here, I'm not going to tell him not to fucking spark
yeah,
that
Yeah, fuck
bitch.
That.
That was another reason I like this location, because, like, say I ever did get somebody
Zonin's
really big.
Is right down the road.
That and the airport's right there. Like,
true.
I could fucking fly somebody in and just get them in for a podcast. I was trying to get Steve-O to come on, but they just egged me the whole time. Like
Steve-O's going through a lot of shit right now, though.
And he was on tour, so... And he was, like, when
he
came out...
He just got done. Now he's going on tour again because of Jackass 4.
Yeah.
So he's going to be so fucking busy.
He wasn't taking no shit on his,
plus
like, because we saw him at...
You know, Steve-O owns, like, 5 fucking rehabs in Florida, too, so he's got to fucking finance all those and shit.
He owns rehabs?
Yeah. He literally told Bam Margera... I'll fucking have you in rehab in an hour, and nope.
I didn't know he owned the rehab. I didn't know he was like...
No,
he was defending...
After he went to rehab, he wanted to start helping people. Like, the whole Sea World thing, he changed his whole life around and wanted to help people.
He brought
change
his dog
the world.
With him when he was on tour here. That was pretty sweet, the one he fucking found
in
Peru.
Yeah, Peru.
Oh, really?
Yeah, you ever see that video of the dog he found in Peru? That he,
always
like,
wanted
snuck
to
in
see
hotel.
Him at Funny Bone, but
dude,
I never
was,
had a chance.
It was good.
And then, who's that one dude that just came to Funny Bone?
Trevor Wallace?
Dude,
I wanted to go so
bad. I didn't even know he was here.
You look kind of like him.
I wanted to go see him so
I'm going to see Tracy Morgan's coming.
I'm on lawn duty, dude. I love him, bro.
I'm on lawn duty,
Tracy Morgan's coming?
Yeah.
Dude, I hope they don't shut that shit down again because it's COVID bullshit.
I mean, it's so fucking stupid. I actually protested the other day and got paid for it the other day because of work. Because we were working in this chick's house. She started being like, first day, fine. We're not wearing masks. Second day, somebody walked. This dude, 50-year-old dude's walking on her counter with no drop on it. No booties on his shoes. So he's walking on his counter with her fucking shoes on. She comes home, sees it, freaks out. Her husband brings us booties, you know, little booties to throw on our shoes. It's cool. Then later that day, she's like, all right, anybody who's not vaccinated has to wear a mask. And I'm like, all right. And my boss calls me. He's like, yeah, anybody who's not vaxxed has to wear a mask. I'm like, why don't you just tell her I'm not vaxxed? He's like, no, anybody who's not vaxxed has to wear a mask. I'm like, dude, I'm not wearing a mask. And it was just, there's no logic to it. If you're vaccinated, you could still fucking...
Die from COVID.
You could still carry COVID.
Give COVID.
If you are a mask...
It makes no sense.
If you're a mask fear, I understand it. But be all around. Have actual logic to it.
Don't
be like,
say
you wear a mask,
not
you
vaccine.
Mask, you wear a mask. Everybody wear a mask around me because I'm scared of it because I believe this is... Or trust your fucking immune system or realize that.
Yeah, if you if one person's wearing a mask, everyone wear a mask or not.
Or not. Or yeah, it's either not, you. Yeah.
Just because you are vaccinated, I'm not. You can get COVID just as much as
my
I can.
My favorite part is the only soft. Vaccinated yeah. person was.
Let us know you're soft.
The only vaccinated person was the dude who walked on our counter.
So like, my grandma's a liberal through yeah. and through, and I can't stand going there, but I have to go there. It's my grandma, this and that. She yells at fucking me and my dad all the time. You need to get vaxxed, this and that. And I'm like, I'm young. I don't want to get vaxxed. If I was fucking 60 or 80 years old, where I'm not gonna have kids, blah 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 blah. Whatever. You want me to get vaxxed? Whatever. But so I went to the casino, Turning Stone. I'm fucking walking, you know, the bar, like, right there when you go into, like...
The Leper Lounge?
Yeah, right there.
Yeah.
Big sign, can't come in unless you're vaccinated. I'm like, so how the fuck am I going to get a drink? I was like, fuck it, I'm going to go back upstairs to where the escalators are, that bar right there. I walk in, I'm like, do I need to be vaxxed to come in here to have a drink? No. Sweet. Sat down at the bar, I was like, wait a minute, let me go ask the hostess. I was like, where can I get a drink in the casino where I don't have to be vaxxed? Oh, the Blue Lounge. But once you get your drink, you have to sit down at a slot machine. I was like, so wait. So I went to the Blue Lounge. I fucking get my drink. No one's fucking enforcing me to sit the fuck down. The biggest deal I had was my Heineken in a fucking paper cup with a top and a straw. I'm drinking my Heineken out of a straw. I'm like, whatever. I'm here. I'm going to have fun. It's Christmas. Because I went on Christmas Day. I went on Christmas. I'm like, fuck it. I guess I'm going to have to do what I got to do. And we only went up there because we were going to go stay at a hotel and chill in the jacuzzi and drink. Jacuzzi's broken. So my
dude, I've been trying to book. I want to fucking go up there and chill in the fucking jacuzzi and shit too. None of the fucking rooms are fucking. I don't think they still haven't fixed it.
Why don't you just go drive down to like. It's like 3 hours away. Go to the Poconos Mountains.
Yeah, we were just trying. It was Christmas. I was trying to do that.
The Poconos Mountain, they got the low. They got the slide that you can.
Oh yeah, in your room.
In
your room.
They got a slide so you can go into a pool.
From your room?
From your room.
What?
Not from your room. In your room.
Yeah, in your room.
The pool's like in your room. It's like a hot tub in your room.
There's a hot tub and there's a pool.
Pool in your room.
How much is that?
It's like $300.
And then you got, there's another room there where it's a big-ass jacuzzi, but it's a fucking wine glass. So you're chilling in a jacuzzi in a wine glass. The Poconos Mountains is made for, like, couples. And then they got heart-shaped jacuzzis.
Babe, if you're watching, I know you never watched Look it up. Poconos. Find it. Book a date.
It's fun.
I've never done it.
So now what is that? What's the casino out in Niagara Falls?
The Horseshoe?
I don't think so.
The one Hard Rock? On our side?
Is it Niagara? It's on our side. I'm not allowed in Canada, so it's got to be on this side.
Forget that.
You can literally walk across the bridge.
Yeah,
you know, there's literally a bridge that says that you are now in Canada. So, yeah, but there's nobody checking.
Really?
Yeah.
I've never been, so I don't know.
So you can say you step foot in Canada.
But there's this casino there, and I guess they got jacuzzis in the room, everything, just like the Poconos. But it literally looks over the falls. Like, you're fucking sitting there. And I was thinking, wait, and they'll get a little more snow after this snowstorm, and I was going to book it just to go out there with the girl and have fun and... But now she's like, no, we can't fucking waste the weekend. We got to go riding. I'm like, all right, let's go fucking riding. So I'm not going to argue. Yeah, she rides my old free ride.
Okay.
She broke her knee last year on my free ride. Shattered her knee.
See, I always break something. Season.
I didn't break it. She didn't break the sled. She thought she did. She got up. She's like, is the sled fine? I'm like, I don't give a fuck.
Hit a tree or something?
No, she was fucking, moguls were wicked bad in Barnes Corners, which moguls are the hills that get created because people are assholes like me and John and
she gave it too much pepper.
She hit a mogul, whiskey throttled, got ejected off, and her knee hit the back tunnel and shattered her knee.
Happens to me sometimes, like when you're standing up, like going over the moguls, and like you hit something weird, like you're literally your top of your leg like slams your fucking just like whole. It happens to me more often than like actually what you think.
You know the little foam knee pads you can put on your fucking side panels.
Uh-huh.
I was going to do that, but then I just went riding in Happy Valley the other day, and I noticed where my knees lay.
It's on the inside now.
My knees are out past the fucking side panel, so why would I get knee pads where it's going to be on my inside of my thigh?
I'm thinking about just getting knee pads. Like, yeah. Soft one, because I'm a pussy. I'm soft.
I need
now.
To get knee pads for work. Dude.
I'm soft. Peyton?
I just hate them for when I work. They like they pinch the fucking back of your legs, dude. They have not figured out like the right design for.
They actually they
contractor
just
ones.
So they actually made these new knee pads. I was looking them up. They don't have any straps. So you know how like girls wear those bras that are like
the adhesive.
They're not even adhesive, but they're like a little sticky and they like stick to their boobs. So they stick. They made them for your knees now. So they fucking like suction cup
so
to your
knees.
So they're
basically just some fucking pasties.
See,
for your knees.
Is
some
like
pasties
my
for
sexy.
Your knees.
Like, it ain't the knees,
that's
it's
sexy.
The sides.
Yeah, so you get bruises.
Is where
bruises.
I'm fucking, cause, like, I'm squeezing.
You had a mogul and you're fucking
yeah,
whack,
I'm
whack,
squeezing.
Whack.
I'm not worried about the tips of my knees. I'm fucking the sides.
So I went out last Thursday and it was like, what was it, like 36 up there? And I was fucking like, oh, it's my first time out riding. I don't want to be too cold. Wore a hoodie, wore long johns.
You fucked up.
Fucked up.
Fucked
I'm fucking
up.
Sweating. I'm glad I have a fucking
fucked
bag.
Up.
I literally took my hoodie off, put it in my bag. I was fucking sweating like a son of a bitch. And me and you wear mono suits.
There's no suit.
Mono suits are warm. So you don't even have... You could wear shorts under it.
The only place that's cold is the fucking zipper.
Yep.
I don't care what anyone says. Wherever fucking it's just at your zipper, no matter what that
line. Don't have like a little fucking flat button?
No.
No, they got like a little rubber piece that goes over it, but that doesn't really work that good.
Not when you're going 80.
No.
You need the little flat button.
No, you just wear a hoodie under it and then it doesn't go through your hoodie.
No, it doesn't go through your hoodie, but your hoodie still gets wet.
Mono suits, put the little flat button.
Well, you got FXR.
No.
What do you got? 509. So 509's a little thinner than the FXR ones. My FXR one's actually pretty thick.
It's like the same. So I
you
had
can,
the CKX one. That one was not. That one was thin.
Thin. The Tobe ones are real thin.
Real thin.
But those are like people that go on the mountains.
Yeah.
I just mine's so I can.
They're actually working. Like we're. I mean, I sweat when I get fucking on the moguls because I'm out of shape.
Yeah.
It's not. But that's really about it. What are you doing over there, dude?
I wasn't.
It made me like nervous as shit. I see you like moving your lips. And
no, I was
like,
just fucking.
Like,
I was pantomiming, dude. I was fucking, you know.
But yeah, no, I don't know. My buddy wanted to go to yesterday. I said no. I'm
it's
not
fucking
going.
Negative 10.
At that temperature, I was not going.
No.
And me going to Michigan next Tuesday.
How cold's it gotta be for you not to go?
So I'll go when it's negative 10 if it's not windy. If it's a wind chill of negative 30, and then you're putting on... So you got to imagine, negative 30 wind chill. Then you're on a snowmobile doing fucking 50 to 80 miles an hour. That's another
negative.
You're looking at, yeah, negative 50 and negative 70 because you're going so fast. I had frostbite last year right here because we went out at nighttime and it was fucking negative 15, and I was like, fuck that.
What does that do, frostbite? Like?
Frostbite is... It freezes your nerves wherever it hits your skin, and it looks like you got punched in the eye or something, or you, like, scuffed your eye really bad,
yeah,
but it fucking hurts. It feels like a burn. Literally feels like a burn.
I mean, my best way to say it, it's literally wind burn.
Yeah.
It's, like, it's the reaction to
I feel
cold
like
wind.
As a kid, you just thought frostbite was, like, I don't know, in my mind, like, frostbite, you're done.
No,
well, you got to cut it off.
Like
you got frostbite
like
on your hands.
Your
you got to cut it off.
Yes, you're done.
Yeah, and it
but
depends
when you get
how bad
it, like,
it
something
is.
Something like right here, I mean, you can like lose like feeling in your whole entire. People lose their whole entire cheeks.
So frostbite is a burn. It's wind burn. It's a burn. So you got like five or second degree burn or third degree burn. So if you got like just a
third degree frostbite, you can have different degrees of frostbite.
Yes.
Okay.
So, like, if you have really bad frostbite, that's where people's hands turn black and you got to cut your fingers
that's
off.
Where you get
it'll
that
be like
Mr.
Deeds.
Foot. Yeah.
Mr. Deeds' foot.
Yeah.
And when you get that bad, you got to amputate probably, right?
Yes. Usually, yes.
Because if not, it's basically
it's just
dead.
A dead fucking limb.
Honestly, you have to because it would keep creeping up.
Yeah, and
I think because it's dead and it turns into gangrene.
Yeah, and it would keep rotting. It would rot your
rotten
whole leg.
Foot. That's a band name, dude. Rotten foot.
Rotten foot.
Yeah.
Dude, we've had some good times back in the day. My trap house was a little.
It was a little fucking too crazy, man.
We've had some times. Remember, I put a stripper pole through my ceiling.
I wasn't there for that one.
Me and Hazelmeyer used to me, Hazelmeyer, yeah, Loeffler.
I gotta get you guys both on here too to get a fucking.
We were crazy back then, dude. Fuco, fucking all them guys.
He seems like he's doing all right.
Actually, I think him having a kid changed his life.
I forgot he had a kid.
He just had a
you
kid.
You plan on having a kid?
I can't speak on that right now.
Okay. Well, he's,
but yes, you, in mean, the future.
No, I haven't told the world what I'm having.
He's having a new keyboard.
Let's say
my keyboard funds are going bye-bye.
I've talked to you about you having another kid.
Oh, yeah. No, I'm definitely having, I mean,
I hope so.
Well, yeah, I mean, I don't know. It might be a mailman baby, Lacey. Is it a mailman baby?
I'm never having a... Is it the mailman baby?
Is it Lee's? Is it Lee's?
Is that the mailman?
Yeah, I know him by like.
So I got a question for both of you. Even camera guy over there.
Zach.
His name's Zach?
Yeah.
Well, I'm Zach.
Zach, his name's Zach. Zach.
I got a question for all three of you.
Okay.
Does your... Do you have a significant other? No. All right. Well, this one's directed to you, too.
Okay.
Does your significant other send you 50 TikToks a day?
No. We're pretty... I have a buddy who sends me fucking 50 fucking... He's
Here's
not
my
on...
significant other calling me right now.
I'm at about... I'm not going to lie to you. 3 each a day to each other?
Yeah, we're at about 3 each
day. Like 3 each?
But my buddy... Dude, I got a buddy who sends me... He's not on TikTok, but he's on YouTube, and he sends me about fucking 50 a day, and I have to tell him sometimes, like, yo...
You gotta stop. I can't do it.
My fiance sends me, I shit you not, on a slow day, 15 TikToks. Like, granted, I send her just as many just because she sends it to me, so I feel like I'm
obligated. What percent of them do you fucking actually fuck with?
If I don't watch them,
oh my god, she remembers.
Knows.
She knows.
She'll be like, "Yo, remember that TikTok I sent you earlier?" I was like, "No, I haven't watched them yet." And she's like, "All right, you better go back and watch all
yeah,
of them."
Yeah, mine says that. She's like, "You didn't watch that? That one was funny." I don't care.
I'm gonna keep it real. Me and my girl sit. We went to the bar the other night and just watched TikToks together.
We just fucking got some drinks and some fucking.
What bar?
Barneystone got some clam chowder.
Oh, Barneystone, they got good burgers for the price.
They do, the best price, dude. I. $4.50 for a chicken sandwich or something like that. It's better than McDonald's.
We had, I went to,
you fuck a Barney?
High Market.
I've been there once. I haven't really been there much. So my biggest thing, we go to 3 places, Tully's, Copper Tops, or,
Tully's is overhyped.
I only go there because they got Mahi Mahi sandwiches.
The fucking tuna?
No, Mahi Mahi.
Mahi Mahi's tuna.
No, it's not. It's a dolphin fish. It's not a tuna.
I thought it's a tuna.
It's not. It doesn't even, no, it's not.
I'm pretty sure it's a tuna.
Look it up. It is not. It's, A.K.A. dolphin fish.
Look it up.
So we go there for
talking
that.
Talking about snowmobiles. Now we're talking about fucking fish sandwiches.
Is Mahi Mahi a tuna?
Or we go to Texas Roadhouse. And then in the mornings, we'll go to Rise and Shine.
Ooh, Rise and Shine's good.
Rise and Shine's good.
It's catching your whole sentence.
My favorite place to go for breakfast is Second Chance Diner.
That's the one out in Camillus?
Spot, too. I love it.
Yo, it is the...
Mahi Mahi.
You know the owner?
No, actually, yeah, Garrett Abbey introduced me to the owner, but I don't really remember
his name's Eddie.
And then his little brother's Adam, right? He works there.
Adam does work there.
Adam looks just
He's
like...
tall.
Yes, he looks identical to Garrett Abbey. I swear to God.
I don't know Garrett Abbey.
But he literally...
I don't think I really...
But my girlfriend will go there and drink a fucking Tower Mimosa by herself, and we'll have a blast.
So, dude, what this is saying, dude, the main difference between ahi and mahi is ahi is a tuna, and mahi...
Is not.
Is not.
So mahi mahi is not a tuna.
It's double dolphin.
It's double dolphin. It's a dolphin fish. It's actually a really good looking fish. It looks like my slut.
Yeah, it looks like
blue
mahi
and green.
Tuna.
No, it's not.
All right, in my defense, you understand why I thought ahi and mahi ahi were the same fucking.
It's not though.
That's the same fish and the same.
The best place you'll ever have a mahi mahi sandwich is Captain Hiram's in Palm Bay, Florida. I love it. I go there. I'll order 10 of them and bring.
Is it a redfish or a whitefish?
It's white.
White.
I'm never going to go and get a fish
tuna, the mahi mahi steak, that's what they call it, filet.
I've had the steak.
Literally looks like a piece of tuna, but it tastes nothing like tuna. Nothing like it.
That's
I don't like tuna. I hate
tuna.
See,
I like tuna. I like that too, but I always thought it was just like a different.
Mahi mahi is where it's at. If you're here, it's frozen in here, but it's still good. It brings me back to Florida.
You'd have to go down
days.
South to get some fresh fucking.
But if
it's same, like I drink mojitos, they suck up here.
Yeah,
you go around there.
If you want good fish up here, you're either eating walleye or perch. That's the best fish up here.
Or trout. I mean, there's some people that...
Yeah, trout's good.
I mean, even some people really like... Some people really prefer sunfish.
Sunfish actually is pretty good.
I don't eat
just
fish.
Just small and fucking bony.
Yeah, you don't get a lot. Yeah. But another thing is, like, up here, people eat catfish, too, and I'm not a catfish person at all. Bullheads and that.
I was surprised when I had a sunfish.
Nuggets
with
that, they fry it. They fry shit like that because it has to add, like, the batter adds a texture and a flavor because it's a...
If you cut the cheek muscle out of a walleye, it tastes just like a scallop.
Ooh, I love scallops.
Oh, it's fucking bang.
Fucking, my girl went to Alaska and she brought home mad shit she caught in Alaska. We had a salmon like this big. Our freezer ended up breaking. We had to fucking throw out fucking probably like 10 pounds of halibut, fucking bunch of fucking salmon. Sucked. Luckily, her grandpa lives in Alaska, so he ships that shit like it's fucking rutabagas.
Actually, Leffler just got back like a couple months ago from Maine, and he brought like 60 or 80 fucking lobster tails back.
Hook me up, dude. Tell him to hook me up.
He fucking brought them back, and he bought them for like fucking, I think it was like $6 a lobster tail, and he was selling them for like 20.
Tell him, I'll buy
it.
He goes there like every couple times a year. Dude, I love lobster.
The fucked up thing is I love lobster. And my fiance loves crab legs. Crab legs, you don't get a lot of meat, and they're fucking outrageously priced. Lobster's reasonably priced, and you get better meat.
I feel like you get the same ratio.
I don't think
so. Lobster tail's $60 nowadays.
No, dude, that was a fucking the lobster tail in fucking Baltimore that I paid $62 for no fucking reason.
I went to Del Lago, right? And we went to the steakhouse in Del Lago. And then my buddy Nick, you met Nick, he's the tub guy.
Okay.
So we're there, and we both ordered steaks, which was like already $70 for a fucking steak at the steakhouse. And he goes, "You want to add lobster tails to our steaks?" And I'm like, "I guess. How much is it?" He goes, "It says it's market price." I'm like, "Whatever. Let's do it. We're at the casino. Might as well fucking do it.
We're fucking having a good time."
Spent $75 for a lobster tail. Little guy.
It was 60. The one I got.
What?
The thing that sucked, the one I got in fucking... Because my chiropractor's like, Maine's good for seafood. Or, you know, while we were in Baltimore.
Lobsters.
Baltimore's good for seafood. So I was like, fuck it. I don't know why I thought Maine. Weird types of talk. But so I was like, yeah, dude, fucking Maine. Baltimore is in Maine, isn't it? Why are you laughing at me?
No.
I'm not a map, anyways.
No. Baltimore South, Maine's North.
Right, I know.
Anyways, I'm not looking at it yet because it's down here. Maine's up here. Anyways, yeah, it was a 60. It looked seasoned as fuck, but it was the blandest lobster tail I ever had. Yeah. Like, I looked at it, I'm like, this is about to be.
Yo, those vegetables look like they came out of a microwave.
The best Cajun is dinosaur barbecue Cajun rub. That is by far the best Cajun rub you'll ever have.
Dude, I was about to say, I'm like, they don't got lobster tail at a dinosaur.
Wish
you just
did.
Rub that shit down there.
That could be a good fucking thing if they had fucking
lobster to the menu.
I feel like that's
like, you know how like seafood places have chicken tenders on the menu? The lobster tail have fucking dinosaurs, like for like the fucking bougie dude who goes to dinosaur. It's like, nah, dude, I don't want chicken tenders.
Have you ever had the poutine at Dinosaur?
I don't fucking care for poutine.
What?
Yeah. I love gravy, I love french fries.
I don't know dinosaur, so.
Really?
I think they're mediocre at best.
Okay, so they are now. When they were actually a family-owned company, it was awesome. Yeah. Now it's gone downhill.
They're pretty franchised.
Actually, Nichols Pit Barbecue in Watkins Glen, best barbecue I've ever had, and I've been down south. And I would rather come back up here and have Nichols Pit Barbecue.
You know what's overhyped as fuck is New York City pizza. I think
if you're not eating fucking Twin Trees pizza or Paladino's pizza,
get the fuck out of here. Paladino's,
bro, he had one bad. He likes Mario and Salvo's.
Dude, just wants to sit there. Nah, he ain't never getting my fucking business again.
So I worked at Twin Trees, and you guys probably think Twin Trees wings and pizza are good, right?
Yeah.
We used to eat them every fucking day at the trap house.
I think they're okay.
Okay.
Top five.
The guy that used to work at Twin Trees 3. Would ash his cigarette in the pizza dough.
That's Newport. The flavor.
I think that was the fucking hidden
secret.
It has changed.
Does he still do it?
He's retired.
Yeah, dude, he needs to fucking get back up in there. I'll smoke a Newport next time.
He was literally smoking Newports in the fucking restaurant, ashing right in the fire while I was mixing them.
See, my favorite is Mario and Salvo's.
I love Twin Trees.
My girlfriend's on this. Oh, or my fiance. OIP. It's still fucking hard to say. Do you get like that too with the wife's girlfriend?
Did you have that problem when you first got engaged?
No, I never called her.
Oh, you guys just fucking.
Yeah, I just.
That's why her parents hate you.
I just went to dating day.
Yeah, see, it's different because, like, I've known Tatiana.
I don't really call her my wife, though.
But I've called Tatiana. So me and Tatiana have been off and on for 10 years. So I've called her girlfriend for 10 years. Now it's like, okay, well, switching it to fiance is a little hard. But my fiance's on the OIP kick right now. And I'm like, it's good.
The charred grill wings.
She likes the pizza, the everything pizza. She likes it because it's crispy as fuck.
Which one?
I don't know.
What's the fuck's everything pizza?
She works down the road from here. Yeah. It's everything.
It's the Maddie Dale one. Maddie Dale one.
No, I don't think it's Maddie Dale.
If she works right down the street from here, then.
No, she works at Cryomac. It's like a mile down the road. I think it's East Syracuse.
There's fucking like 5 OIPs out here, though. Though there was one in Bridgeport for a little bit, and then they switched it to a Familia's. Yeah,
that's a Russian place, and they smoke cigarettes back there.
What?
It tastes good
100%, dude. His mother's still... I used to work there. They all smoke cigarettes in the back.
And the pizza tastes good?
Yeah.
Yeah, they're ashing that cigarette. Right there.
I think they got a good meatball sub. I've been on a meatball sub,
dude. I like a good chicken parm sub.
I've eaten a good 10 meatball subs this year.
What?
I think I've eaten probably 10 meatball subs this year, too.
Yeah, dude. I don't know what it is. I've been on a kick. Have you ever had a Firehouse?
16 days.
Yeah, dude, probably about 10. 10 meatball subs, give or take.
No.
give or take 5.
No,
I've never had Firehouse.
Dude, Firehouse has...
I stick with my shop, Direct Subs is right next door, so, like...
I've never had Direct Subs, and I bet you they have a good
Subway's,
one.
Like, down here.
Yeah, no, Direct Subway's subs. Fucking down here. I go to Firehouse. That's my sub spot, dude. Their meatballs could have better flavor, but the structure of the sandwich is so A1 that it fucking makes up for everything. Like, you never lose a meatball.
What about Jimmy John's? Have you been eating there?
Fuck Jimmy John's.
I've never ate there. Everyone says their subs are tiny for the price.
And they got one type of bread.
Oh, really?
What, dude, if you want to go get a turkey sandwich on white, go there. That's all you can get there. It's
Brooklyn
like,
Pickle, not the one in North Syracuse, but the Brooklyn Pickle on Burnett. It was good.
I thought that was like a bougie ass restaurant my whole life.
Me
like,
too. I thought it was like fucking.
Like Olive Garden.
It's not.
Lucky Sevens.
Okay, now we're talking.
Lucky Sevens.
I'll take my hat off for Lucky Sevens, dude. You ever have Lucky Sevens?
No.
What?
Dude, all right, so let me tell you what we got from Lucky Sevens the other day.
A chicken tender mac and cheese kind of guy.
Either way, dude.
It'd be good there.
So my man got some General Tso's chicken. I got stuffed shells and pinatas. The only thing that was bad were the empanadas, but I don't know if you know how wide of a range of fucking different foods that, you know, we went from Chinese food, Italian, and Mexican food.
Sounds like the fucking,
They got everything there. The only thing they did wrong was empanadas.
Dude, when are they going to open the fucking buffet back up is what I want to know.
Soon. They redid the whole thing.
They have it open for, like, VIP.
Yeah,
VIP
you
got to
be fucking platinum.
You got to be fucking sucking some fucking...
Yeah, some lean. Oh, wait, you know whose dad's platinum? Rick's.
Ricky Kenny?
Yeah, dude!
So,
how's his dad plano?
Have you ever had Steak and Shake?
Steak and Shake?
Steak and Shake.
Yeah,
down
it's
south?
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay?
It's okay.
I thought Steak and Shake
was
the
one
best.
One.
Yeah, we did have
steak. I didn't get to have mine, actually.
You didn't have... Oh, actually, it was good. That was...
The garlic burger is... I could eat 20 garlic burgers right now.
Don't even talk about it.
Yeah, that was the one show, though, that was garbage, though, wasn't it?
I don't know. I didn't get to eat my cheeseburger that I bought.
That venue was trash.
Yo, I was so addicted to Steak and Shake at one point. When my mom was coming up from Pennsylvania, I made her stop at Steak and Shake. And then and she'd bring it to me. And then on the way back to PA.
That's some shit, this fat ass.
On the way back to PA, I have fucking Krispy Kremes at the shop right now.
Oh, yeah, dude. He's got a local. Mizzle's the local plug.
Mizzle.
Right? Dude,
he works.
He's right next door. Yeah. He's right next door. He's got the plug. He brings
Krispy
Kremes. No,
it's not the plug. They did
a fundraiser for
Cicero Falcons cheerleaders.
Just fucking Krispy Kremes for an extra 20 of fucking.
No,
dozen.
So when my mom went back to PA. I made her mail me my fucking next day air my fucking Steak and Shake back to me. It was bad.
Is it good reheated?
I'll eat that shit cold. I don't even give a fuck. It's good, dude. I was addicted to it so bad.
I'm gonna have to reheat it again because most of the tour was a blur. And not even due to the fact that, like, it wasn't even that, like, yeah, we were fucking partying, but it was just so much fucking nonstop.
We didn't stop.
It was a 5-day day. You know what
Besides
I'm saying?
Besides Robert slept.
Yeah, Robert slept is fucking
soft.
I'm not on camera right now, or? Oh, he's changing.
Yeah, Robert was soft.
No shit. You guys got the fucking setup here, man.
My hair's looking decent right now.
And then, like, when we want to watch a video or something, this way we pull it up or something. Yeah.
That's dope.
And then we can switch it over, too, so, like, they can see what we're watching and whatnot.
No shit.
I fucking, you know, we got this man right here helped me really tune it up because I was having...
That's pretty much the same fucking computer I got at my shop, except it's a little small. I got the iMac.
Yeah.
Brand new.
They're all pretty much, at a certain point, the same
it's
guy.
It's all the same.
Fucking, I used to have trouble getting multiple, like, I can only get 3 mics to work prior on my old setup, but he helped it so we can get as many mics as we want going in too. What I would like to get is, like, just one boom mic, what I think would be cool, so I could have 8 people in here, but when you get a dozen people, it gets annoying, too, because everybody's just fucking...
So, you know the podcast where the Island Boys and Jake Paul fucking fought?
I mean,
I watched that
like
6 fucking times.
Really?
I was just dying laughing because I literally have a genuine hate for them fucking dudes.
The Pauls or the Island Boys?
Both. Both.
More of the Island Boys.
I have a slight respect for the Pauls, and just due to the fact that they.
Okay, the boxing aspect, I don't have respect for them, but the podcast stuff, I do. If that makes any sense.
I don't know them personally. From their view is to be hated. Like, that's kind of like, so that's why I don't give them
I think
that.
That's what Island Boys are just looking for fame. And they're retarded. They're literally dumb.
I don't know.
Yeah, they're on the spectrum.
I can't stand them.
Yeah, they're on
If I seen them out in public, I would go back to jail.
I used to say that about Famous
Dax. I can't see
And I've said it a few times on the podcast, too, so I'm kind of stuck to it, that if I ever see Famous Dax in person, I'm going to just fucking fight him.
Not even
Do you know
fight
who
him.
He is?
No, but
Dexter! He's fucking...
Oh, I think so.
Dexter!
So, that's like the Island Boys, dude. Like, if I've seen the Island Boys and I have a fucking straight shot for them, I don't care if they're looking at me or not, I'm fucking hitting.
Fucking right in the sea, sucker.
Yeah. Fucking real funny bit about them where he's like, these kids' parents... His dad's like the third most successful orthodontist in Florida, probably, and his mom's a state senator. He's like, that's where these kids are from. Like, just making up, because that's what they look like, too. Yeah. The Island Boy.
I'm an Island Boy, but I've never even been to an island. You know what I'm saying? You, like, grew up in fucking Florida, bro. That's not an island. That's a peninsula, and you're not
Cuba.
An Island Boy. If you were from Key West, maybe I would consider
They're
you
Cuban.
An Island Boy.
I saw a video where, like, he was reading the comment.
He can't read.
He's like, you couldn't even read that comment. He said that to him. He's like, he was like, that was his insult back to the person. He's like, the dude's like, what the fuck?
He's like, you can't even read. He's like, you can't even read.
So, like, to ballpark in a similar fame category is like 6ix9ine. But 6ix9ine actually had had a few fucking songs that got me going.
But you gotta imagine when 6ix9ine just went through all this fucking bullshit, being a rat, whatever, blah blah blah. We'll not get on that subject. But he's been giving back to the community. He actually has been giving, like, he went to fucking, I think it was like Puerto Rico or something, and he was fucking giving fucking money out just randomly. I mean,
doing it for fame and shit, whatever. Yeah.
But he's actually been doing like some actual shit, like not just fucking bullshit. He's been doing like actual shit.
My man over here makes boot heelys, dude.
Man, if you could bring up can you bring up TikTok on that thing? Man, if you could bring
probably
up my TikTok.
Watch it. Yeah, dude,
I got a TikTok on here. You
want
to see me fucking smoking an e-cig and rolling down
boot
a goof?
New boot goofing.
New boot goofing. Dude, I tried to do it with that.
With the sound?
But trying to fucking do a little dance with heelys in the back of the boot.
Impossible. Impossible. No. You should still just
And
it's
it
fucked
with
up because me and my me and my cousin's boyfriend made him. His name's Zach. We made him. It's a funny fucking thing, dude. Like, I watched TikTok and this dude was on TikTok making boot scoots, and I was like, all right, fuck, I got a shitty pair of cowboy boots, you know, a little shitty pair of cowboy boots. And I was like, all right now I'm going to fucking cut the heel out, and I'm going to fucking epoxy a fucking... I literally got brand new heelys, took a sawzall to them, cut them up, took the plate out, epoxied it in the back of my boot, popped the wheel in. I really didn't want to wait for it to dry, but I let it dry for about 3-4 hours, and I fucking went out, and it fucking worked, and I was like, all right, TikTok, here we go. Let's fucking get a new TikTok going. literally in my hill at Panta Lake, it fucking cuts down pretty good. I'm fucking I didn't think, like, you gotta get it perfect so you don't fucking go one way or the other. And I fucking was zooming down the hill. Them boot scoots.
What's your
I think it's Gucci Kush 420, like everything.
Sounds like my old email address.
Dude, I've had it since PlayStation 2.
Did you ever get a PS5?
It's actually at Zach Buckley 1. ZACKBUCKLEY 1. Oh, well, we can listen on here.
We can technically, like, you can hear yourself when you're talking to him. Oh, backwards. I'm only getting one ear with this.
Yeah, it's the one side. I gotta bring the block back.
You're good.
That's boot, scoot, and boogie.
So which one am I looking for?
One, two, three, four.
Seventh
five,
video.
Seven down. It's me with boots on.
Bro, I remember when I saw you doing this. So I was like, this is sick as fuck. I want a pair of, like, fives with it.
Dude, I can put them in anything with a large heel.
Yeah, no, that's the only problem is I don't think a five, like, that's the probably biggest heel in a Jordan you can
get.
Maybe
some, like, Nike boots. It's got to be something with a heel.
Want them in fives. Maybe double down. We'll get another pair of fives, glue a second sole to that bad boy.
No, what we could do is, oh, here it is.
Oh, yeah, let's play this real quick.
Them diamonds in it. Where'd you get that magic beans with them windows? What we could do is, so if you have two pairs of fives,
okay,
same size,
I do,
take the insole out because I'm gonna have to cut through your first insole so it'll fit in there, right? And then put a new insole on
right
top,
on top
of,
it.
So you'll have two soles, so it'll be real squishy, but you'll still have, we could do it. I guarantee we could do it.
No.
100%. I'll make it work.
That should be fucking hell.
I made it work so good on my boots that I could, you know, the piece, when you get Heelys, you've had Heelys before,
yeah,
right? You know the piece you can take the wheel out and put it in?
Yeah.
I can do that with my fucking boots. I can take the piece out and put the other piece in so I can still walk.
What wheel
in my
do
boots.
You get?
It's the same wheel. I literally cut the fucking Heelys up and I take that wheel and just that. The... I just take.
So you're going through three pairs of shoes.
Yeah, you have to buy a pair of Heelys, which is $55, which ain't shit.
Well, I'm about to just go to the mall and pop the wheel out the fucking display.
You can't, because I have to cut it open and take the plate out of the Heely. I need the whole Heely.
How fucking big?
But if you get kids' wheel, that's what I ordered.
Oh,
I ordered a kid's Heely.
A smaller wheel, right?
No, it's same wheel, same plate, it's cheaper. My girlfriend fits in kids' shoes, so that's how I learned that.
Oh, yeah.
Fiance.
He's a new boot goofing.
New boot goofing.
How big is the plate, you think?
Goofing. It's like that.
Like width-wise, that for the wheel.
About that.
Yeah.
So if you put...
Yeah, dude. Yeah, that's
just
fucking...
put two pieces of fucking foam in.
Bro, I'm out of it.
And not even that. You don't even have to have two pairs of fives. If you just go get the fucking Dr. Scholl's fucking thing. Yeah. So you just, that's like $12.
Because there's just going to be a hole all the way through. Is
all the way through your
saying.
Shit, yes. Yeah. And then we'll put the plate in, and then you just put a fucking sole over it, and you're good.
Which realistically, I mean, if I just pulled out the fucking... The actual insole.
No, because I'm going to cut through that. You want that in there so it's thicker. And then you put another insole in, and it hides you from being on that plastic on your
So heel. That you need to cut through as well. I just don't feel like that did anything structure-wise holding it
in. It will, because I'm going to fucking glue your insole in.
Okay.
And then I'm going to glue it in, and then...
That's going to be fucking sick, dude.
If you want them, I'll make them.
Does Vinny want when he says? It's already in motion. It's already in his head.
It is.
He needs some new boot goofins.
Really, any size Heelys the same size? So I can just... obviously.
Go to Heelys.com. Heelys is where it's at, man. If you want... we can make Heelys out of anything.
Anyhow.
You want nines, you want fucking fives,
you want
fucking
15s?
Nines would be a good one. They got a fucking thick sole.
Trying to think of other Jordans. I used to collect Jordans. Now I don't.
I mean, I know. It's funny to, like, you know what I'm saying? Like you had, like, the heatest collection in the fucking game.
And
to,
now I have.
Now you're just new boot.
Cowboy boots every day of my life.
We'd be growing. We change.
If I don't have cowboy boots on, I got slides on, Crocs on.
If you ain't crocking, you ain't rocking.
Or I have my snowmobile boots on.
Have you thought about making a pair of fucking Heely Crocs?
I don't think the heel's big enough.
No, you're gonna have to add on, dude.
You can't really add. I mean,
you can fucking add on to a Croc.
Spray foam it. That's what I'm saying. That'd be fun though. Yeah, I think I could. Because like imagine who the fuck would put it in the Crocs.
That's what I'm saying. That's why.
I might have to.
The boot was fucking crazy.
The boot, but that wasn't my idea. Yeah. I seen it on TikTok.
So that's why we
someone
gotta switch it up, dude. We'll
have to do
Heely.
Some like Crocs, or maybe we'll come up with like maybe muck boots.
I don't think there's enough heel.
In muck boots? You can get work muck boots. They got like the fucking, or like a pair of Chippewas or something.
Have you ever heard of Knicks boots?
They
have the
light up. Knicks boots?
You want to pay $600 for boots?
Dude, I was watching Tox, dude, and they got brought up, and like they got me. You know what I mean? They made a great talk, and they sold me. I'm like, I'm going to buy a new fucking pair of boots.
I was thinking about it. I wanted to because that's just the cheapest.
That's for the shit ones.
For the Knicks,
and they're nice.
They're made to your foot.
Yeah,
they're custom made to your foot. Like they make them.
I mean,
they don't
pay
just
for that.
They don't.
They're
just
fancy.
Like,
they're
the most
like,
expensive pair of shoes I have are $600.
And hashtag new boot goofing no.
Maybe
$650.
The
Gucci's.
My most expensive pair of shoes when I was collecting shoes would have been the Brazil pack, but it was two pairs of shoes.
Dude, but not right now. The Brazil pack ain't worth nothing right now.
Isn't that crazy?
It's not worth nothing. I bought a dead stock pair of Brazil 6s for $250.
That's unreal. Back then, they were worth money.
Yeah, I bought it for $250. Honestly, I think you were half the reason I bought that, because I remember seeing them. I'm like, he's like $250 for these. And I was like,
but so the CP3s were the ones in that pack.
I thought those were fucking ugly as
really?
Shit.
Really? I like
dude.
Those ones.
I can't remember what. Dude, I had this fucking.
My still favorite
that
pair.
That white and green speckle was just so fucking fire on it.
But I like the fucking weird shit like that.
No, that's why I
like
about the
6s
too.
My favorite pair of any shoe that I've ever had were ice creams.
Really?
I loved them. Funny story is, me and Leffler were fucking around, and I accidentally kicked my shoe off, and it landed in the fire, so my ice creams melted. And then my second favorite pair were the Bel Airs.
I love the Bel Airs.
I love
I've had
the
two
Bel
pairs.
Airs.
James has one of my pairs, and then
I want to get another pair, but
you see the ugly.
When am
fucking
I gonna fucking
re-release?
Yeah.
I wear them all the time.
I had the Bel Air 5s.
Never clean them.
And then I had the Bel Air. What was the fucking 6 rings? I had the Bel Air 6
okay,
rings.
Okay. Yeah.
And then I just didn't want them anymore. I still have the Bel Air 6 rings, but I sold the Bel Air 5s after all my shit happened. And
I wear the Fresh Prince 5s to work. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. How they came out with the grapes with no lace holes. That's what I wear to work. People give me, there's this dude who always gives me shit. He's like, why'd you fuck those up? Because I used to four-wheel in them. So I would just fucking slide them
they're
on.
Fucking shoes. In my eyes now, they're fucking shoes.
They've always, like, yes, I like to have a nice rotation, but at the end
of
the day.
If I have a nice pair of shoes, they're fucking dress shoes.
My work boots are $200. Why not fucking wear a $200 pair of Jordans? Like, what's the fucking difference? I'm more comfortable in these fucking Jordans than any boots. And if my bros don't care, I'm wearing the fucking Jordans.
Yeah. And not only that, is like, if you're going to go out to, like, the casino or something to have fun, I'm wearing dress shoes. I'm going to have dress pants on, dress shoes, a nice fucking button-down shirt.
I had to learn that the hard way because fucking growing up with y'all motherfuckers, I thought, you know, oh, I'm going to get some J's. I'm going to be fly.
That's what my fucking mindset was. I'm like, yo, I need to have every pair that I like of Jordans. And I had fucking a whole closet to the brim full. I had fucking everything.
And all it does is make haters.
It makes haters. And why do you need that many shoes?
Bro, I think about it all the time. I probably have about 12 to like 15 grand in shoes total. And it's like.
Why? Why?
Exactly.
Dude, Randy Latre's been selling all his shit.
I brought it out of a dead sock pair from 2013. Wore them twice. The fucking heels fell off.
Busted.
They decompose.
Wore them twice and the fucking heels fell off. And it's like, what? Like, why? I joked about, you ever seen Mr. Megorium's Magic Emporium or whatever? You know how like he has, he bought enough pairs of shoes to last him his entire life. I always joke that I think if I kept them in rotation right, I would never have to buy another pair of shoes.
So if you wore those shoes, they wouldn't have fell apart.
No, yeah, I know. That's why.
But since you didn't wear them, they fell apart.
It's fucked up. That's why I've literally been.
It's like a car. If you car sits, it falls crumbles. Apart. If you fucking drive it, it lasts.
It's so weird. You gotta like.
That's why I drive my Civic.
You gotta have a nice balance of fucking using shit and not abusing it.
I can't wait. Like, don't get me wrong, I love snowmobiling. It's been a late winter. We haven't really got much snow. I've been thinking, like, I just want it to fucking really hammer down with snow, or I want it all to melt and we have an early spring so I can get my Camaro out. I want to drive my fucking Camaro, bro. That shit's so fun.
You just got that shit, too.
It's fun. It's a fun car. My fiance is fucking...
Didn't you buy that from right up the street from me? Didn't you get that at Tech Force?
Yeah, Tech Force.
Yeah.
And she wants it out just as much as I do because she wants to drive it. She loves driving that fucking thing. I told her, I was like, we're going to have to get two because...
I'm not a fast guy, dude. I don't go fast.
It's not even the fact of being fast. It's just really nice to drive.
Is it?
It's nice to drive. Like, when the power is always there. But if you want to just cruise around, it's a nice car just to drive around. People look at you. It's all blacked out. It's, like, murdered out. So it's nice.
I think I might get a Beamer. My uncle swore. He had the Mustang. He had the Camaro. He had a Caddy and a Beamer, and he swears by his favorite car. He's like, if you're getting something that you want to enjoy driving... that you didn't buy for any reason besides the driving, he says.
Especially in the winters. Yeah. You know what I mean? The Camaro's put away. I can't drive it. I drive it 6 months a year, so it's a luxury car to me. But realistically, how much you really drive it, I spend $650 a month on it, and it sits for 6 months. It's like my snowmobile. We drive it for fucking 2 months, and it sits for fucking 10 months.
There was a 1965 Mercedes-Benz that was on fucking Facebook Market. I watched it go from $7,000 to $4,000 to $6,000 to $5,000 to sold. And I was so pissed. This is probably over a year I watched it. And, like, I wanted it so fucking bad. But I was just like, I'm just going to store it 90% of the fucking time. I literally want it for, like, 2 music video shots. And then I'm going to fucking store the thing. And maybe break it out one nice summer day where I get caught in the fucking rain. Because I wanted a convertible. I was like, I just want a fucking convertible.
I'm not big on convertibles, but...
I like the wind in my hair, right? It was from after crashing the fucking moped, and my girlfriend wouldn't ride on that thing with me.
I wonder why.
I wonder why.
I was all right. I got caught in the rain. If it didn't rain that day, I would have made it home safe. And I was trying to get home faster, too, because it was...
raining, so like, that's when you slow
and
down.
It was coming slow. It was soft, too. It was like a little fucking... I'm like, I'm fucking get home, that fucking...
Nope.
No.
Another thing that sucks is the people who like help me up, they're like, we're gonna tell the cops somebody hit you. And took off. Dude.
That's not good.
Dude, my homegirl got in a hit and run, got about $50,000.
Yeah, but they have to find the person.
No. My homegirl's insurance called her up. They're like, What do you think you need? She's like, I don't know, like 60. They're like, we'll give you 50,000. That was her insurance company. For emotional distress and shit from a hit and run.
No shit.
Yeah. But anyways, I had a gnarly concussion.
I got hit on a motorcycle, and I only got fucking like 23.
And maybe it's different for motorcycles. Also, I'm not licensed or...
I was licensed.
I didn't have a motorcycle.
Last thing you need to do is say you got hit.
It was mad funny, too. The cop's like, do you got your license? I'm like, I don't have a motorcycle license. I'm like, what's this? It was like some weed. I'm like, oh, I got some weed. I'm not in trouble. I'm like, no. That shit sucked, dude.
Cops are a little different now than they were back in the day. Back in the day, you would have been like, oh, you got weed in your pocket, get on the fucking ground. Now dude, it's like, whatever.
We got pulled over one license. Night. It was like 2 in the morning. It was me and my girlfriend. The cops were fucked up. Like, you know, we smell weed, get out of the car. They're like, is there any weed in the car? I'm like, yeah, you know, there's a little bit in the grinder in the fucking glove compartment. They find it. They're like, where's the dabs? What the fuck are you talking about? They're like, where's the fucking dabs? I'm like, I don't have any dabs. They're like, they just kept asking, where are the dabs? I'm like, dude. Like, why do you want me to get in more trouble?
Yeah, that's
like, there's what they some were... weed in there if you want to give me... And then he just left the weed in there and told us to go home. Like, dude.
Some cops are assholes. Some cops are nice. You just got to find the right
ones.
Where's
the weed?
And try not to find...
You, motherfucker!
Try not to find any cops. Trust me. Between me and you, you already know my fucking running with cops aren't always the greatest.
Yeah, you don't have the hottest rap sheet.
No, my rap sheet's here and there.
But, you know, we all get in a little trouble.
Or tied up.
You're a wild card, though. You've done some wild... What's funny, too, is you're like a docile wild card. It's interesting.
Yeah, I'm not like crazy, but like crazy shit happens to me.
You're
like, I'm not out there just being like fucking wild, but like wild shit just attracts to me.
It really fucking does, man.
I've been through hell and back. But I've also had fun my whole life. My whole life I've had fun. Nothing but fun.
That's the, I think that's the number one point of living, too. Like, and that's one of the reasons you got so much of my respect, is I know you don't fucking waste none of these days on fucking this earth, dude. I've done some shit.
Dude, one of my funnest memories is with James and SP going down to fucking Florida, fucking getting down there, having nowhere to stay, sleeping on Miami Beach, fucking having a blast, fake IDs, going into clubs. I was fucking like 18, fucking just having a blast.
That, dude, that...
When you're 18, I'm telling you, if there's someone out there that's 18 years old, go on fucking road trips and have fun. Yeah,
Don't sleep on the beach, dude.
Do it when you're young, because when you're older, like our age...
I'm serious.
Would you sleep on a beach right now?
Right now, no.
Yeah, because you're older. If you were 18 years old and you're out in fucking no man's land fucking having fun, you're sleeping on a beach because you're out there having fun. We're older, we don't want to fucking do that.
They asked me to jump back.
I'll go fucking buy a hotel. Fuck that.
They asked me to jump back on the Rift Tour, and I was thinking to save money because, I got to pay for all my own hotels, and my own way to get there is literally just driving there in my car, sleeping in my car, and finding fucking Planet Fitness as the shower in. And I was thinking about it. I'm like, I ain't fucking doing that shit. Fuck that, no. Dude. Fuck no. I ain't struggling.
Riff Air got like a tour bus and shit?
Yeah, they did a tour bus. But like, you got to think, there's only like 6 or 8 beds on the tour bus. Mm. If we did the tour bus, it's 800 a person a night. Or no, my bad. It's 800 for the tour bus a night. So we would all fucking divide that between 8 of us. So it'd be like $100 a night.
That's not 15, too bad.
On like a 15-day tour, it'd be like $1,500, which... It cost me about $15,000 to do my first 5-day tour.
So it would have been almost worth it.
Oh yeah, if they were doing the tour bus, but they weren't doing the tour bus. They didn't do the tour bus our first half of the leg. They did it the second half, but it was still already, that thing was filled. We'll probably end up wrapping up soon too, because we're fucking just lollygagging. I try to keep them slim, like in an hour and a half range.
Yeah, that's what most shit is, hour. But I was just looking to see what time it was. I ain't got nothing to really do.
About an hour 30.
Sean Smith, he's one of my biggest fans, dude. I was actually just with him before. The biggest podcast fan. He's probably sitting there watching it right now, just smoking a blunt. I was just with him at the farmer's market.
Do you just do it on Facebook?
It goes live on Facebook, and then before we leave, we upload it to YouTube as well.
No shit.
And I've been meaning to start chopping them down and uploading them to, like, Spotify and all that shit. But I...
Make a TikTok, too.
I have TikTok.
Like, funny snips to, like, TikTok and all that crazy shit. Get your fucking name out there. More views, more people.
It's... Huh? Yeah, soon it'll be uploaded. It'll be streaming to both at the same time. But we go live on Facebook. It sucks. I honestly have been thinking about stop going live because he even complained. He's like, why don't you ever talk back to me? You know what I'm saying?
If you look up there, just, you know what I mean, have like a little ding when someone comments, and you can look up there and see what they're saying. And like, if they ask a question, you can answer the question. So, like, say we're live right now and someone has a snowmobile question, they could ask me or John.
Which usually that is the hope, and that's the reason I go live. But 9 out of 10, it's my boy Sean saying, what's good? What's good?
What's good, bro? What's good, brother?
Yeah, you know. But what's up, Sean? What's up, player? What's up, pimp? Him and my girlfriend's ex-coworker, Joe, is like he never misses an episode.
No shit.
Should be mad funny. My girl would be working. He would, like, come out to her and be like, yo, he's live now. He's fucking. She's like, why are we working? He's like, fuck that shit.
Especially like a lot of people, you just gotta keep sharing it and doing it, getting out there.
It's more just continuing to do it. Like,
yeah, if you just don't do it, then you're not gonna get views. If you keep doing it, that's why when I seen that podcast with your last one with
my chiropractor.
Yeah, I was like, yo, get me and John on there.
And that's funny because he's told it's funny hearing him talk. He's like me and Buckley are like the same guy. He said, we get along mad well. I'm like, it's funny that you say that because I never even thought about you two, like, just fucking, you guys are vibe, dude, because, you're both fucking good people just out here just fucking.
As soon as I seen it, I was like, dude, get me and John on there. It'd be fucking fun just hanging out, chilling, fucking, and talking about, we talk about snowmobiles a lot, but that's just because if you were a snowmobiler, you'd understand.
100%.
It's like the motocross world. You love motocross. Snowmobile, you love snowmobiling. It's like...
I could talk about rap for hours. I'd rather sit here and listen to you guys, honestly, talk about something I don't know.
And then you'll, like, learn.
That's how I learn it. Yeah.
I'm telling you right now, if you ever want to get out on the trails...
Probably never going to happen. I might rent... I'll rent one. I'll go rent one.
Why rent one? I have fucking four.
Yeah, I know. You have a fucking fleet. I'm going to rent one.
I'm going
to break it.
I have helmets. I have gloves. I have boots. I have everything.
I mean,
you
I
need.
Snowboard, so I have a decent amount of shit, but I don't know. If it's...
No.
No. Okay.
No. You don't want snowboard stuff. Okay. CJ Hines tried to go out and snowboard stuff. Next day's at Ingles buying fucking snowmobile stuff.
Your nutsack is gonna be frozen.
Yeah, it's a lot frozen. Colder than you think.
I had fucking CJ over at my house fucking on Halloween a couple years ago. Not last Halloween, the year before. It was a good time.
Yeah, I'm telling you right now, I'll get you out there, and you'll see how fun it is. Don't go balls to the wall like me and John, but go out and just have fun. You'll literally probably go buy a snowmobile. I shit you not.
I honestly
financial-wise, probably not, but you'll want one. I promise you. Like, your first time riding a snowmobile.
Jet
skis, I feel that way. Jet ski, I fucking...
Riding them since I was, like, 5 years old.
Yeah, though. Me too.
So it's not, like, I used to race dirt bikes.
My uncle used to ride fucking snowmobiles, and I just never had an appeal for it. I'm not a motor guy.
I stopped for a few years, like, when I got...
My,
shit.
My girlfriend's not a motor person, and she's been begging me for the last year and a half, I want to go snowmobile.
My girlfriend would love it.
It's because you're out in the woods. You have no phone. You have no access. You're fucking just cruising. It's beautiful scenery everywhere. Tell me the gorge. The gorge trail.
I've seen it way too many fucking times.
Well, that's how
it's cool for the first time. I'm not going to say it's not. But now that I've went past it 355 fucking times, it's the same trail.
Yes, but at the first time, you're like, damn, this is nice being out here with your boys.
Oh, yeah. No, it's nice.
That's what I liked about
that.
The moped, too, is that, also, you know, it's a cold fucking day. Helmet on.
It's not fun.
I'm away from everybody. Like, when I'm driving, I'm fucking texting. I'm fucking worrying about what song I'm listening to.
Moped, you're just...
Because you can't use your phone. Because you, like, that's why I like being on
the
things
box,
that you
I
don't
put my
use
packs
the
in
phone.
It. Nobody's pulling over a nerd on a fucking moped, dude. That dude ain't...
Yeah, I know. But that's the thing with like snowmobiles. You're out there, you got your helmet on, you're in your enclosed area. That's one reason I don't really like the chatterbox where I can talk to my friends. But I do like it because then I could be like, yo, I'm hungry, let's stop. Yo, there's a fucking person coming. Yo, this and that. Yo, icy corner.
I think it gets abused a little bit though.
If you ride with the wrong people. Like if me and John went out, we would only fucking talk to each other probably like.
That's why me and like my buddy, like for us, like what it would be is like, see, I keep myself like basically so I can just see him, just like I can see him. I don't really want to just be fucking peppered with snow dust, be dirty the whole time, and just get hit with rocks and shit. So
no.
I stay a distance back.
Side by side?
No. First of all, you're an asshole if you do that because the trails really aren't
left
big
and right.
I'm gonna tell you right now though, if I didn't have the. Well, I had Cena's last year, but this year I got chatterboxes. If I didn't have it, and when Tatiana crashed, I wouldn't have known she crashed. Because I wouldn't have known. I would have been waiting for her at the next stop sign, and I wouldn't have known. Right when she crashed, she fucking screamed in her fucking helmet, and I knew that she crashed. I turned right around.
So
I was there in a second.
Just talking in it, it talks. You don't have to hit a button to talk.
In the Cenas, but the Cenas are not that great. The
no,
chatterboxes.
The Cenas are for like motorcycles because there's like no hills. You're not going through like wooded areas.
Yeah.
The Cenas don't
Bluetooth.
Go through.
The chatterbox is a walkie-talkie. I can talk to you up to 5 fucking miles.
Yes.
Through
but
the
do
woods.
Do you have to hit a button or no?
You don't have to.
You can set it up
you
to
can,
automatic. Voice,
yes, but it, you'll
but it picks up your
motor.
Can. Like it picks up your motor being, or like when you hit the brakes or something. Say you hit a fucking. Tree.
So or if you breathe into it wrong, it'll fucking catch it up. So if the button's just way easier. But when me and my girlfriend ride, I have to have it set up to where she could just talk because if she crashes, she's not going to have the fucking button.
Yeah.
But if I didn't have the button, it would have took me a good half hour to realize that she crashed because the stop sign wasn't way up there.
You
and
sat there for 10, 15 minutes. Because
you wouldn't have known. Like, you're just like, oh, she's taking her sweet time because it's nothing.
It's girls take their sweet time on a snowmobile, so it's whatever. I'm going to wait. No, she crashed, so I knew she crashed. I literally turned around. I fucking got right to her, and we got her off the trail.
So for safe riding with a squad, have a chatterbox.
Definitely a chatterbox.
Good to know. And what are those, bro? What are those fucking...
If you go off chatterbox.com, it's $300 for one. Or if you go through my buddy Chris Haber, you can get them for you for $250.
And Chris Haber's got them for the low, low. And so what, it comes with just one headset?
It comes with the headphones for inside your helmet. It comes with the piece that goes on your handlebars. And it comes with the mics, two separate mics. It's got the
So you get a
mic.
Pair, though, right? It comes with at least, so, I mean, it's
$500 for two.
$500 for two.
It's fucking useless by yourself.
I buy one and he buys one, then that's that. But if you have like a girlfriend or something, then it's good to buy the two.
Well, let's say you buy one and you're not going out with a homie. Could you, like, hypothetically, like, scroll through channels if you got hurt?
And try to find someone, yeah. Or if I... So when I was just... None of my friends had them last year. I had it so I could take calls and listen to music.
So, yeah, then you can just hook up.
Yeah, I like listening to music when I ride. It's soothing. I fucking just jam out and fucking ride. And then someone's, like, trying to talk to me.
Fucking storm, dude.
Yeah, like, someone's trying to talk to me when we stop at a stop sign and I'm, like, looking at them and I'm, like... Can't hear you. I got music playing, dial it down.
I just put my Wish McCollins on.
I was talking about that, dude. We need a remake of Sled Storm. You remember that shit? You ever play that?
That game was.
That's where I fucking learned to Rob Zombie. Damn, through the bridges and ram through my dragon.
That and we need another new Twist of Metal because that last Twist of Metal was kind of booty cheeks.
I didn't even play it.
It wasn't that great.
They just need to fucking revamp the concept. Like, don't even just give us the graphics we have. In the game we used to play.
Yep.
Nobody would complain.
No.
Nope.
That's what half of the shit they did
it with Crash Bandicoot, and it was fucking Crash Bandicoot's tits.
Yeah, but they just remastered that. But I'm saying I want new shit, but like the same.
I don't even care about new shit. You can't make it new. See, that's what's the problem.
They want to add too much shit into it.
They do overkill it. They do with Call of Duty, too. It's like, I almost.
Dude, back in the day, Call of Duty was the best game. Now I don't even like playing it because it's just fucking over. It's just too much.
Every time I got a fucking update, that's what I fucking hate. I didn't turn my PlayStation on for like 3 or 4
months.
That's
why I stuck with Battlefield. Yeah. Battlefield is pretty much the same game through and through, and like it's more realistic. So I play the zombies on this new VR. I got the VR headset, the Oculus 2. I don't even turn my PlayStation on. I play the Oculus.
I've heard nothing but good things. I haven't immediately get one. But
I love the Oculus, dude. Went to a strip club with Nate Mezzatesta the other day in Oculus, and it's just a rowdy time. You could literally have podcasts in VR. We could literally sit here if we had three of them, and we could be in. He could be watching all three cameras what we're watching, and have a camera over us in VR, and we could be doing crazy shit in VR. It's fucking insane. It's watch a VR podcast when you go home, and you'll be like, "What the fuck, bro?" Hmm. It's crazy. We could be sitting at a strip club in VR.
So you wait. You how did? All right, so you went to a strip club. You were at home, though.
I was sitting on my couch.
And whose perspective at the strip clubs were you?
There's other people there that dress up as girls. There's girls there that dress up as girls. Just fucking...
And what are they, wearing glasses?
It could be anime. Yeah, you're in goggles. And you just make a character, and it could be a fucking stripper. It could be a fucking alien dancing.
What I'm saying is, like, are you at an actual strip club in real life, or is it the metaverse?
Metaverse.
So you've actually dove in there? Like, it's actually, that's how...
It's fun, bro. It's fucking a riot. I was playing paintball with Nate Mezzatesta. I was playing.
You got any property in the metaverse?
You get your own like fucking little house that you can fucking make. There's different apps. There's like the.
You know how you can like buy a house next to Snoop Dogg right now?
Really?
Yeah, you can go to Snoop Dogg's parties. He's selling land next to his crib in the metaverse.
There's crazy shit in there. You can go to fucking.
Dude, because see, that's
where you can
go to
concerts in the metaverse. You can go to fucking Monster Jam in the metaverse. You go to watch football games in the metaverse.
That's the main application that my buddy.
You could be at your house. I could be at my house. John could be at his house. We put the fucking VR headset on, and we could literally go to the same fucking house, sit on the same couch, talk to each other, and watch a football game. You could watch Netflix. I watched Happy Gilmore the other day.
Have you ever seen Ready Player One?
Huh?
You ever seen the movie Ready Player One?
No. Oh, yeah.
With the VR headset, too. Yeah. That's where we're heading.
It is. I think so. It's crazy. Dude,
but it fucking tits, too. It is. Like,
VR fucking everything now. There's VR porn.
I've been doing now because, like, when I used to have the fucking, what was it, the Curved Galaxy?
Yeah.
And that came out with the fucking headset.
Yeah, but this is, like, a thing. You don't even need, like, a PlayStation.
No, I've seen the Oculus.
People think, like, you need a PlayStation or anything
else. A lot of people
don't
realize it's all right there.
It's all right there. You just need your phone.
And then, like, because my buddy's pretty tech savvy, so he's got into his
For some of the crazier shits, you have to mirror it off of your computer, but... For most of the stuff, like if you want to play like Skyrim VR, you gotta have a computer. But it's still
fun. Have they gotten the graphics better? I mean, the last few times I played it.
I love it. I was playing like it's equivalent to Fortnite. It's like something I don't know. It's equivalent to Fortnite, and you're literally climbing up walls, shooting people. It's fucking.
I played this thing. I was just like the top half of a monkey, in a fucking enclosure. You can do. He just fucking monkey so you've around.
Had one. You've had one on.
Yeah.
Oh, dude. As soon I was at Nate Mazzatesta's house for a party, and he's like, "I'm gonna strap you into this thing." I was in it for probably fucking 10 minutes. I'm screaming to Tatiana, "We're going to Walmart tomorrow. We're buying one of these motherfuckers, dude." I literally went the next day and bought one. I fucking hooked it up. I went in and I was playing boxing. I was, dude, 2 rounds of boxing. I was fucking taking my shirt off, ready to die.
So, like, I used my buddies once and I was like, cool. And then the next time I went hung out, I, like, used it again, dude. And I put it on and I was just like, yo, you've been fucking sweating in this motherfucker. Fucking Richie
Cena. Yeah, you got to buy the fucking actual. There's so many, like, mods to it. There's the foam one, which that's like you don't want when you're playing like a sweaty game. You want the fucking
rubber one,
yeah, and it's nice. And then you can get the battery packs that hook on, so you could play for like 16 hours instead of 2.
It's too much shit.
Dude, it's fun. It's literally 16. I have the PS5. I don't even turn it on. What do
virtual reality fucking strippers look like?
It's like anime. It's literally anime.
They dump them out for you and shit.
Yeah, I was like, I turned into a big ass black guy with a huge dong.
Really? You can swing around. A dick?
Yeah, dude, you can do whatever you want. It's crazy. It's crazy. It's fun, dude. VR is fun.
They got like VR weed. Can we like roll up there?
Actually, they do have like smoke sessions you could do in VR. It's crazy. Dude, you think of it, it's in VR. It's in VR. You can.
When do you think they're going to start monitoring that and censoring that and making that so you can't have your big fucking black cock hanging out and that's, like, not PC?
I don't think they're ever going to because you got to imagine you can just make it. It's like a fucking... It's... They might eventually because, like, you know what I mean? Like, how... Like
copywriting and shit? Cause like,
well, not even that. It's like, you know how, like, Grand Theft Auto, you could shoot people's heads off back in the day, and I can't. Or you could get with a hooker, and I can't. Like, shit like that.
Yeah,
like,
that's more what I mean, like...
But I don't think they're ever going to nerf it crazy. But if you go to a private lobby, like a modded server, it's the same thing. You're going to be able to fucking do what you want because it's a private server, modded lobbies. Have
you seen the modded GTA servers that they have now?
Crazy as fuck. They just do the role-playing shit. Crazy, yeah, fucking, I'm a cop. And then someone, like, fucks up and they, like, jump a car where it's unrealistic. Oh, you're booted from the server because you're not acting like it's real life.
Yeah.
It's crazy how they have it now.
Yeah. I got a buddy who does it. He just wears a raccoon mask and searches through trash.
And he gets paid for it, probably. Yeah,
people pay
you to come into their server to
he got initiated into a gang, dude. They jumped him in and shit.
Yo, there's fucking
chain, gave him a new chain.
Dude, there's fucking shit on Grand Theft Auto where they like have banks and stuff. People get paid to stand out in front of that fucking bank and don't fucking move. They'll pay you just to stay in there. Like real money in real life, pay you to stand there. It's unreal.
What's cool in the mods too is they made it because like I guess what I've heard about it is there's a few creators from the game who like left. And they created the mod. So it's like you can go in any building. They made it so all the cars are the real actual cars and shit.
And you can fucking build shit now too. It's crazy. Like back in the day when like Sims came out, you could build a house
That's what it basically is. Yeah. It's like Sims but Grand Theft Auto, which is what kind of like we want.
It is what we want. You know what I mean? Because the new Sims that came out sucks. You can't fucking do shit in the Sims. They're trying to like push the story mode on you. I don't want to play story. I want to build a fucking house.
I just want to bang my wife.
Yeah, like, and I want to drown random people. Like, it's like Roller Coaster Tycoon. I want to fucking crush this roller coaster into the side of a building and watch these people die.
So I got sick of, like, you know, we'd be chilling on one side of my living room. I have, like, a yoga boo on the other side of the living room. I get sick of having to pass a blunt from the other person. So I wanted to get, like, a model train that went around the fucking room.
Dude, that'd
like,
be dope. Fucking...
But then I was like, all right, I'm going to get into model trains. That's going to be my new thing. I'm like, fuck it. I'm going to be model train guy. And I'm
dude, there's a lot of cool shit out there. Like, I got an RC cars for
Oh, dude, I was going to, but that's a pricey one, too.
Expensive.
Yeah, you like, can easily drop $5,000 on a fucking car.
Not even that. I have an X-Max and a Creighton 8S. They're both $1,000 a piece. Without any mods, without any batteries, without anything. I love it, though. It's fun.
I like it, too, but I hate
expensive.
Those numbers.
It's expensive.
I hate those numbers.
It's not like your $150
fucking
truck from Walmart.
No, not at all. Fucking. But then I was thinking, I want to get into model roller coasters. That'd
those
be fun.
Those are cool with like the fucking like old Lego piece things and shit.
I want like no, I want it like legit. Real ones? I want like it to be legit. Ones? Like I want it to be like a fucking actual fucking.
Dude, they make some crazy shit now. See, I told my fiance that I want to get into Legos again. Legos? And then I went and looked at the prices of Legos nowadays.
Wild. Wild. Not I'm even like, fun.
What?
Not even fun.
For a little fucking little $150
beans.
For... Bro, I got too, because there was a period of time where I'm like, I'm going to get back into Legos too, and I bought a big bin.
And I'm and a I Harry thought, Potter fan. Out the ass. Outrageous. I love Harry Potter. And then I was like, I seen all these Lego Harry Potter things. For the Hogwarts castle, it's like $450. I'm like,
I just rewatched the series like this week.
Really?
Yeah.
All I've been to Harry Potter World 3 times. Love it.
Yeah, I've gone once. I'm excited to go again. I was trying to get a bunch of people to go the other day, but they're being fucking babies.
I want to go again. Dude, I love let's fucking go to Florida. That's my favorite.
I love Florida.
So Tatiana wants to go, I don't know, this year or next year, but that's where we got engaged. So she wants to make it like an every year thing is go to where we got. It's like an anniversary thing.
I've wanted to like, do you guys stay there at Orlando?
Yeah, last time we stayed in Cabana Bay, which is Orlando Resort. You get early access to the water park.
See, we didn't do the water park last time. I want to do the water park.
You've never been to the Volcano Bay?
No.
Yeah. You'll never go to any other water park that makes fucking Darien Lake or any place around here water park look like a fucking...
I think Orlando's in general makes any fucking park look like a fucking jank park.
I'm telling you right now, Volcano Bay has this thing.
Epcot it's like sucks a, dick.
The rapid river at Volcano Bay, you have to wear a life vest. It's like fucking going down a fucking river.
It's no joke?
It's no joke.
I want that. It's awesome. You've obviously done Disneyland, right?
No, I've never been to Disney.
Don't waste your fucking money. Really? Fucking
the only reason I would go to Disney is because of Charlotte. He's got no choice. Tatiana's daughter.
That's different. That's a different experience.
Yeah, I want to go because of her.
That's different.
Not as for an myself. Adult, it sucks. As an adult. And we went to...
The Star Wars thing might be cool.
Disney Springs. When we just went down and we got engaged, we went to Disney Springs. Every building we had to go in, we had to wear a mask.
They advertise you don't need to wear a mask at Disney until you get into a line or you go into a store.
Universal, no mask.
No, they don't.
They are right now because of the whole COVID thing.
Bro, but I guarantee summer fat hits. I ate acid when I was there. Dude. I was tripping balls.
Universal's where it's at. Dude, and it's fun.
I honestly wish I saved the acid for Disneyland because Disneyland was fucking boring. And I was like, Universal didn't even need this. Like, no. It was
when you're insane.
Dude, the King Kong ride is fucking timeless. It's been there for years and it's so good.
I went when it was Halloween. So I went to Halloween Horror Nights.
Is it fucking as sick as people make it out to be?
Dude, I would pay money to go to it right now. It was we went to fucking, I think, there's like 10 haunted houses.
Did you guys dress up?
No, we didn't dress up. You can't wear a mask when you go. So you can only dress up, but you can't wear a mask, obviously, for reasons. So, like, I went, and it was an experience out the ass.
You ever been to Universal?
When I was younger.
Dude, if you have a chance, go in October.
No, we were going to go this year. We actually wanted to go this year.
Go in September, October, and go to Halloween Horror Nights. It is.
Do they do it like the whole month? Like all
September and October.
They do that? That's kind of cool. I thought they maybe just did it in like October or something.
We went to the end of September, and it was...
Dude, I'm going to go home and fucking like start booking. I want to just stay there right for now, like 3-4 days. Do the whole park. We didn't have the fucking express passes either last time.
If you go during the week, you do not need express passes.
No?
We went
during the week, though.
We went on a Tuesday.
We went on a Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday. Like, we went, like, for, like, a Monday, Tuesday, really? Wednesday, Thursday
when we
trip.
Went in the end of... Well, when did you go? Was kids in school?
No. Kids were out of school.
Been dealing with COVID. It was when they first opened up, too, from COVID.
Yeah.
So that's the thing, too, is go when kids are in school. If you go when kids are in school, there's no one fucking there in the week.
Yeah.
And then you got fucking no lines. I didn't have a line at all during the week, but on the weekends, there was 2 to 3 hour waits. Dude, so if you go on the weekend, express pass all day.
We got blessed, too. Like, you know the Transformers ride? It was closed down, closed down, closed down. We were about to leave. As soon as we were walking out, they literally, like, opened it up.
Revamped, what was it, Skull Island? Is that it?
The King Kong ride?
Yeah.
Dude, I fucking love the King Kong ride.
No, not the King Kong.
That's Skull Island.
Skull Island, is it?
Skull Island's the King Kong ride.
No, Poseidon. Poseidon was closed when we went.
I don't think it was open when we went there.
They just revamped it all. They painted everything.
I know they got rid of Shrek 4D.
Yep, they just got rid of Shrek 4D.
So they're
going to
be putting something in, which is...
I think it's the Minions. The
Minions have been there.
No, but I think
they're making it bigger.
Expanding the Minions.
We didn't even do the Minions that time. It's such a fucking...
They don't have anything for kids really there.
No, that's...
So if they expand Shrek and the Minions, they expand that. Then you got shit for kids to come in and do.
Did you ride the Fast and the Furious ride?
Yeah.
That's their worst ride.
It is definitely the worst ride.
There's a scene where Vin Diesel's holding onto the bus and the helicopter. Yeah,
it's not the greatest.
That one was...
Honestly, one of my favorite rides is the Mummy ride. It's the fucking classic, dude.
And it's
E.T.,
a classic.
The E.T. ride was fucking... It
was closed when we
really?
Went. Yeah.
I missed the
Back to the Future ride was sick.
Yeah. But the E.T. ride... It's more or less, it's fucking boring, but it's more or less, you're there for the E.T. experience. You know what I'm saying? You're on the fucking pedal bicycle, yeah. And you're flying over,
like
the model train shit. No, they have it. I went on it last time I was there.
I could have swore I did not see the E.T. thing.
It's all back way behind the Simpsons. And then the Simpsons land is, dude, drinking.
That's cool for
drinking.
Kids.
I love the Simpsons. I was drinking fucking Duff beer the whole time I was in there.
That's pretty dope.
And a fucking trick.
The fucking Harry Potter is sick, dude. Diagon Alley is fucking
unreal. The trick, though, is buy a Universal cup and you get like refills. $4 off every refill. So you're saving so much fucking money.
So you know how there's the train going between parks?
Yeah.
That's right outside of Diagon Alley?
Yeah.
The thing that pisses me off the most is that they didn't create an entrance through the train. Like, you've seen the Harry Potter movies.
Yeah.
I got into a big argument, dude, because I'm tripping. And, like, I thought the train was a ride. I didn't realize. And, like, in my mind...
It's technically a ride,
yeah,
because
they have
not.
It set up, like, even, like, the entrance and the fast pass and shit. And I thought, I'm like, oh, that's how we get in Harry Potter world. Got into, like, a big argument because they're like, no, we'll go around this way and we went around a different way to get in Diagon Alley. I'm like, this is the cheap way. I wanted to go through the fucking train station.
No, that's just to get to park to park. Because Harry Potter...
The butterbeer is so good.
Dude, have you had the fucking frozen butterbeer?
No.
Dude, the frozen butterbeer is way better, dude. It's a fucking slushy with the butterbeer.
I like the warmness of the butterbeer.
So you got both Harry Potter worlds, and that train connects both of them, so you can go to both of them. But you have to have a pass to both parks. But so we had a deal.
We did one park one day and one park the other day.
Yeah, we went for 5 days, so we did... the water park for 2 days and we did 3 days in the other ones and we'd like Mitch mash all around where we wanted to go. One day we did one thing, one day we did the other, and then that day we went to both parks to finish up anything we didn't do.
Or buy stuff
so you didn't want to buy it that day to carry it around. We'd go back just to buy it and then go back to the hotel. But the hotel we stayed at, Cabana Bay, it's got like 6 pools, water slides, everything else. It's right next to fucking Volcano Bay.
Yeah.
But that's Disney.
That's Disney.
Oh.
Disney and Universal are not the same.
See, Universal owns the rights to the rides that they do, and that's the reason they're so advanced. I want to go to Universal Japan because I feel like the regulations are a little slimmer there.
Yeah.
And they got
ain't no regulations.
And they got some badass shit.
So Universal owned... So J.K. Rowling was trying to have Harry Potter at Disney... But Disney wanted to buy all the rights to Harry Potter, and they were going to build Harry Potter the way they wanted. J.K. Rowling's not with that. So J.K. Rowling went to Universal, and Universal actually was their producer anyways. And then they were like, you create it. Fuck that. You create everything.
Which, if you go through the line, it's
J.K.
pretty fucking...
Rowling, if there's anything out there that is Harry Potter and doesn't have J.K. Rowling's involvement, she sues you for it.
Yeah, of course.
Why not?
That's her shit. Yeah, that's her shit.
And actually, a funny thing is I've seen this TikTok, and they're saying J.K. Rowling just made Harry Potter off of Star Wars. They're saying it's a bootlegged Star Wars with shitty lightsabers. Fucking shitty uncle. Harry Potter has a shitty uncle. Fucking kid doesn't have his parents. Fucking, you know what I mean? It's literally when the dude made it.
What house do you think
you'd be in? I've done 50 tests on Gryffindor. You're
Gryffindor? What wand do you rock?
I actually have 6 wands.
You should be snake and wands.
I have the Elder Wand. I have Harry Potter's wand. I have... I think Professor Snape's wand.
Double D's wands.
Yeah. Well, actually, it's not Dumbledore's wand. Dumbledore has a wand, and it's not the Elder Wand. The Elder Wand is not Dumbledore's wand, technically.
Because it's technically Harry's.
No, it's not.
No, I think
The Elder Wand is from the story behind the three brothers with the Deathly Hallows. Grindelwald had the Elder Wand before Dumbledore. He got it from Grindelwald when he defeated Grindelwald. And then that's when, you know what I mean, Malfoy got it from Dumbledore. Dumbledore actually has a wand. If you look it up, Dumbledore's wand is different from when he was a child until he got the Elder Wand.
Well, the wand I have is Dumbledore's wand, but it is the Elder Wand.
Yeah, so it's under Dumbledore because that's the wand he uses in the movies. Yeah. But if you actually go and do research, Universal Studios has Dumbledore's wand too, okay. The actual original, his one from like high school and stuff.
So one thing I was just thinking, if you remember the story of the Deathly Hallows, there was, you know, there's the cloak, there's the stone, there's the fucking, the wand. The wand was given him to by Death, and then he was murdered in his sleep, and the wand was taken from him. Was that Dumbledore who murdered him in his sleep?
No, because, so there's a really, really weird story behind it, but Grindelwald had the wand before him.
Grindelwald was the first person to have the wand, wasn't he?
I don't think so. There's like a lot of stories behind it. I'm not really. I should know this, obviously, because I'm like a crazy Harry Potter fan. But so what it's happened so much was
content when you watch. I just watched them all.
I think it was Harry Potter's ancestors that all had. It was like the three brothers. I think those are Harry Potter's ancestors that had them, because Harry Potter's dad had the cloak.
Yeah.
Harry Potter's uncle,
you know what I didn't like, Harry is Potter's that
uncle had the stone, so and then Grindelwald had the fucking wand.
Do you remember? And maybe it's just a chunk of it. So the Forever Stone or whatever, the Eternity Stone, I thought was the Sorcerer's Stone. And what I don't understand is they even said the Sorcerer's Stone has the power to bring somebody back to life.
Isn't it this?
It's not. It's a different. Not? At least in the movie, and I think this is just poor directing. Like, it was a way different. Like, the Sorcerer's Stone was, like, this fucking fat. The little stone Harry gets is, like, this big. There's also another scene where, and I'm glad I remember this, because I was talking to another friend, and I was trying to remember the continuity errors I didn't like. There's a scene where Hagrid's burying Aragorn, the fucking big spider.
Yeah.
And it's the size of this table.
Yes, and in the movie, he's
fucking Aragorn's huge, and its babies are the size of this table. So I just, me and my girlfriend argued. I'm like, that's not fucking that Aragorn.
It is. Spiders shrink when they die.
Yeah, I guess. It looked still too small.
Yes.
It looked...
In my eyes, it did look too small.
I felt like it should have been at least...
Because when he takes the venom out of the fucking...
The tooth and shit. Yeah, because he was fucking... He was way bigger. Way bigger. That was like the size of one of his babies.
Yeah, I gotta get going soon.
Yeah, we gotta wrap it up anyway. So, again, thank you everybody for tuning in. Thank you, Zach, for coming out. Thank you, John,
See ya.
For doing this thing. Yeah.